Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome to the show. I'm David Knight, and I'm the one that's live from Austin, Texas. Alex is going to be live from London later on in the show. He's going to be joining us at the bottom of the hour, and we've got special reports there from other staff on there in London Live. Lee Ann McAdoo's got a report about some breaking corruption scandals in the UK. Now, this is interesting because this is what Nick Clegg, who is the Deputy Prime Minister of the UK, said. He said, "It remains a place where power is hoarded, decisions are opaque, and the people who take those decisions are not properly held to account." Sounds like Bilderberg, doesn't it? Actually, he was talking about Westminster. He was talking about the lobbying scandal that is breaking there. It's really shaking people up. They've got three different members of parliament. Actually, they were House of Lords that resigned as part of a journalist sting at the end of the week and over the weekend. And these people who resigned were peers Lord Cunningham, Lord Mackenzie, Ulster Unionist peer Lord Laird. You know, when you start calling people Lord, it's almost like you're just begging to be used. So many of these politicians act like they're the Lord to start with. But they also had a Tory member of parliament, Patrick Mercer. Now, the thing these guys all had in common was that journalists who were posing as lobbyists went to them and proposed influence peddling to them and got them on videotape accepting it. And the amazing thing that happened after this was that several of these people who were caught in the scam said, "I'm going to fight these charges because I didn't accept any money." Well, of course they didn't accept any money. It was a sting. It was all made up. They weren't going to pay them money. So that's one of the most amazing excuses for unethical behavior I've ever seen. But Clegg also wrote, he wrote an op-ed piece on Monday in the Daily Telegraph, and he said, "What they're seeing here with this influence peddling is really the political equivalent of Groundhog Day and indicative of a wider problem." Yeah, it really is. You know, when you look at what's going on at Bilderberg, and you look at the fact that they've got at least five politicians from the UK, as well as five major bankers, and you've got two major financial newspapers, The Economist and The Financial Times, are all in attendance there. And when you look at how secretive that is, they're talking about registering lobbyists in the UK and having full disclosure. Well, what about Bilderberg? This is so much larger. There was a story that broke on Sunday. We actually had it on our website, and it didn't ring a bell with me. I realized they were British politicians, but I didn't know exactly who these guys were. And we had it on Infowars that said Ed Balls and George Osborne were going to be attending Bilderberg. Well, those guys are the Chancellor of the Exchequer and the Shadow Chancellor of the Exchequer. Now, the way that works is that the party that's in power has a cabinet just like here. But unlike here, they have a shadow cabinet from the opposition. So they have a person who is going to essentially shadow his counterpart in the government and critique what he's doing. So George Osborne is the shadow chancellor, and you know, we've got a shadow government going in Bilderberg, and they're both going to the Bilderberg conference. These are the guys who are like the treasury, head of the treasury department. They're the exchequer, the people who essentially, I guess you could say, write the checks. Maybe that's where that came from. But they are they are the financial side of the government there at the UK. And the fact that the very highest levels of the financial cabinet would be there of both parties sheds a lot of light on the same problem that we've got here in America, and that is full-spectrum dominance of the political system by the global elites. They own both parties. And it's interesting, they've now taken Nick Clegg, who is a kind of a third party that's come into to play here, and Nick Clegg has been kind of thrown into this corruption scandal. They're going to hang this all on Nick Clegg, tell him he's got to clean up the swamp, and if he doesn't, they can basically push their ethical problems off on him. We'll be right back with some more reports about that and Alex Jones at the bottom of the hour. Stay tuned.
K Kalben Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soap that is triple concentrated and made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a free catalog and buy American-made products. Order the sampler, a 1 to 2 month supply, or get a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. You're getting soap products twice as good as what you're using now. This is an amazing deal, and you will love the way real soap makes your skin feel. Call 1-800-340-7091 or visit www.5starsoap.com. Alex and his staff have used these earth-friendly, pure soaps for years. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a catalog.
You prepare by purchasing gold, food, and firearms. But if you don't have a home security system, then you're missing a critical weapon in your arsenal for home protection. When you're sleeping or away from home, who's watching out for intruders? Check out Simply Safe. It's a new do-it-yourself home security system that is completely wireless. Go to GetSimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is independent and off the grid. It runs on battery power, so even if the grid goes down, you're protected. It's completely customizable, so you can use it in your home, business, boat, trailer, storage unit, or shed. Get SimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is also ridiculously easy to install yourself in under 20 minutes, so there's no need to let a stranger into your home. If you move or need to relocate, you can take the system with you wherever you go. You aren't always at home, but Simply Safe will stand guard, protecting your property 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Again, that's GetSimplySafe.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back. I'm David Knight. We're going to have Alex Jones with us live from London with some other Infowar reporters. That'll be at the bottom of the hour. And we were just talking about the breaking lobbyist scandals in the UK and how similar they are to what's going on with Bilderberg, and yet very few people are still talking about Bilderberg. As I said before, Nick Clegg said, and think about this as Bilderberg. I'm going to read this one more time and just put in Bilderberg instead of Westminster, which is what he said. Bilderberg remains a place where power is hoarded, decisions are opaque, and the people who make those decisions are not properly held to account. That's exactly what's going on. You couldn't describe Bilderberg any better than you could the scandals that are going on there with lobbies, because that's essentially what it is. It's a lobbying scandal. And this is what he also said on the BBC. He says, I regard it a little bit like eradicating malaria in Africa. You use a bit of disinfectant on the mosquito, which is a statutory registry would be, but we have to clean out the stinking swamp, which is particularly the House of Lords, where there is a very nasty whiff of dirty money the whole time. Yeah, that's exactly. We got a very nasty whiff of dirty money the whole time coming from these secretive Bilderberg meetings. And it looks like they're kind of recoiling back from some of the publicity. We've got an article on Infowars.com that's linked on Drudge Report about the Bilderberg Group considering a press conference. It looks like they're really feeling the heat, and looks like there's some discussion inside the group about going a little bit more open and having a little bit more full disclosure to people. And this article from Infowars, it says, Paul Joseph Watson writes, If a member or a representative from Bilderberg does not speak publicly about the organization it does speak, it would be an unprecedented move. However, anyone expecting the group to admit that it is a shadow government manipulating world affairs behind closed doors is probably going to be disappointed. Exactly. Once they come in with this, they are not going to come out and have full disclosure. They're going to spin it. They're going to say, see, there's really nothing to hide. We're not really hiding anything. We're going to be very open and upfront about what's going on here. We also have an article on Infowars, and all of our Bilderberg coverage is on a special site, Infowars.com/B. That's where we're consolidating all the information about Bilderberg. It's also on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. In this article from Urien Massin, he says, British Bilderberg participant decries the group's secrecy. This is Sherard Cooper Coles. He's kind of the CEO or director of BAE, which is a very, very large defense contractor, has over 80,000 employees worldwide, selling into the military, part of the military industrial complex. He says that even those inside the perimeter are victims of Bilderberg's steel ring of secrecy. He says, I'm honored to have been asked to go, but it's crazy. The organizers wouldn't tell us where we were going to stay until a couple of weeks beforehand. And he added, some people had to book their private jets in advance. Isn't that a shame? I mean, isn't that a shame that they don't have enough time to book their private jets in advance? They might have to travel with the rest of us rabble and have the guys with blue gloves go all over their bodies. We wouldn't have that happen. We've got some other breaking news here. We've got the Texas legislature is looking at a drone bill. Now, Perry has not decided whether or not he's going to sign it. And quite frankly, when I look at it, I'm kind of undecided about it as well, because it makes a Class C misdemeanor for any private or public entity that uses an unmanned aircraft to capture an image of an individual or privately owned real property in Texas with the intent to conduct surveillance on the individual property captured in the image. So this could be something of a red herring, and because they have numerous exemptions for law enforcement, of course. So it might be something that really just restricts private photography. Not really clear that that's going to be something that we want to see. Also breaking, there's a lot of news like drones that just keep coming back, and so does gun control. And part of the gun control front, of course, is the UN Arms Trade Treaty. And there's an article here from DC Clothesline, it's kind of a blogger here, and he's talking about why hasn't Obama signed the UN Arms Treaty? What is he waiting for? And he says many have suggested the signature will come under cover of darkness sometime in August when Congress is not in town. That's what we're really worried about. You know, they have been very cagey with the timing of the UN Arms Trade Treaty. And understand that the UN Arms Trade Treaty is really about further registration, getting more and more detail and extending it, making it broader, making it deeper, the information that they keep on people. And I believe that this has been the central thrust of this round of gun control all along, that they're eventually going to go, of course, as they've said. We've even had the mayor of Austin, or the second to the mayor, I guess, say that Martinez say that he wanted to go to confiscation eventually. But I think what they're focusing on right now is registration. And as an excuse for that, they're talking about the travel of arms back and forth across borders. You know, like the government did with Fast and Furious. You know, they sent all these arms back and forth and used that as a false flag attack so they could then come in with the arms trade treaty. Unfortunately, it kind of blew up in their face. And it wasn't so much that America cared about all the Mexicans that got killed with the arms that the ATF smuggled over into Mexico to make the Second Amendment look bad, but we had an American law enforcement officer killed. And so that changed everything, got the attention of Congress, and their initial UN Arms Trade Treaty was scheduled to happen last July. And they really couldn't turn that around. Even with the shooting in Colorado exactly a week before the vote was to occur, they didn't get any traction from that. So they delayed it. They said, we'll do it after the election because we don't want American politics to get involved in it. Right. They were going to do something in the lame duck session, except that on the day of the election, as it was apparent that Obama was going to get reelected and they were going to have more Democrat senators, they announced that they were not going to do it in the lame duck session, but they were going to do it in March, which they did. The U.S. and other nations signed on to the U.N. arms trade treaty. It still has to be signed. It still has to be passed by the Senate. But here's the key. It has to be passed by two-thirds of the Senate, but only if two-thirds of the senators who are present. That's why this is a very dangerous time as they come up to summer recess. They have fewer people in town. We might see them pull something like this. Obama has done this type of thing before, signing the NDAA into effect on New Year's Eve. He likes to do things, pretend that he's not going to do anything, wait for people to stop paying attention, and then do it essentially under cover of darkness or when nobody is looking. So we have to keep a careful eye out on the UN Arms Trade Treaty. That's going to be used as an excuse to track and to register people. And of course, what it really does, now they've played around with the language. Language was stronger at one point, then they weakened the language. But the point is that they are ceding this power to the United Nations. And once they cede that power to the United Nations can then come back with a simple majority vote and change exactly how this thing works. So that's the point. The main point about the UN Arms Trade Treaty is that it is a ceding of power to the UN that they should not be getting, that violates our Constitution. And of course, there'll be constitutional fights over that if it does get signed in. Well, going back to Bilderberg, there's another interesting article from The Guardian, from Charlie Skelton of The Guardian. And he's been one of the people who's been following and reporting on Bilderberg for several years. He started back in 2009. And he has an interesting report from a meeting, and it's actually kind of comical, his account of it. He talks about how it was kind of a mixture, an odd mix of residents from around the local area worried about the possibility of tire damage to their lawn, and the other half were journalists from around the world worried about the geopolitical implications of a conference at which BAE, Stratfor, and General Petraeus will be discussing, quote, Africa's challenges. And that's interesting right there, the fact that this year, for the first time, they've put out a list of the topics that they're going to be covering. Now, of course, we don't know if those are real because it's a very secretive meeting. They're going to great lengths to keep everybody out of there. So they could be talking about whatever they want to, but they've given us a list of topics. When they start talking about Africa's challenges, you kind of have to wonder what kind of challenges they're looking at, especially when you've got Petraeus there. You know, when they talk about the surge, they could have been talking about the Iraq troop surge, or they could have been talking about the surge in production of cocaine that came out of Afghanistan while the U.S. Army was occupying it. It had been dropped from the Taliban in control down to about 10% of the world supply, but under the U.S. control, it shot back up to 90%. That's the real surge that nobody is talking about. And of course, Petraeus has a lot of experience, not only as a commanding general, but also as essentially presiding over the largest production of cocaine in the world. So he's uniquely qualified to be there. And if you saw Luke Radowski's video of the award given to Henry Kissinger, the Intrepid Award given to him by General Petraeus, forget this, you won't believe this, defending freedom and democracy. Henry Kissinger, defending freedom and democracy. And Petraeus was just gushing up to him, actually kissing up to him, and actually physically did kiss him on the cheeks. You know, Petraeus really needs to pay more attention to who he's kissing. Now the two of them are at Bilderberg, and they're talking about what's going to happen there. And it's getting out to a lot of other media. We've even got a video here from the International Business Times, where we've got a correspondent who is, I don't know if I'm pronouncing his name correctly, Andrew Kakabadze, perhaps. I don't know if I'm pronouncing his name correctly, but let's play a little bit of that video.
In one sense, all it is a conference of invitation-only people attending. In another sense, it's probably one of the most influential bodies in the world. Established in 1954, European and American interests. The people who were involved in conspiracy theory thinking think it was there to generate wealth. It wasn't. It was there to prevent war. After the Second World War, fundamentally, the elite...
Yeah, pause it right there. Pause it right there.
US.
Now, it wasn't about naked financial interest. It was there for peace, right? That's why you've got all of these military-industrial complex people there. Have we had peace? We've had 60 years of constant war. But in that 60 years, they have established a European Union and the euro, which is what they were really after. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
GCN listeners have their minds wide open, and open minds are inventive minds. America urgently needs new products and services to grow companies and to create new jobs. I'm Russ Weinzimmer of Russ Weinzimmer & Associates PC, a national law firm helping individuals and small companies across the U.S. As a GCN listener myself, I know this country is in deep trouble and it's time to take action. Even if you've never worked with a patent attorney before, we will work with you to get strong strategic protection for your invention. Just contact us for a free consultation to see if you can become a client. We are registered patent attorneys, so all consultations are completely confidential. Just go to strategicpatentlaw.com or call 800-621-3654 for your free consultation. That's 800-621-3654 or go to strategicpatentlaw.com. From your mind to the marketplace.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Don't throw away leftovers. Instead, throw all your leftovers, vegetable peels, eggshells, coffee grounds, pizza crusts, and more into the Bokashi. If you love to garden and compost but don't like the hassle of turning a compost bin or the smell, then check out the EM Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System from Terraganics. Finally, a way to recycle all your food and plant waste safely and effectively and stop using fertilizers. The EM Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System. Rather than decomposition, the Bokashi system uses fermentation to break down waste, so it takes less time to create nutrient-dense humus for crops or gardens with no turning and no obnoxious odors. To learn more and order your Bokashi online, visit terraganics.com and click on the orange button. That's terraganics.com, spelled T-E-R-A-G-A-N-I-X.com, or call 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Recycle all your food wastes in about 6 weeks with the Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System from terraganics.com. Terraganics, life's getting better.
Big business has discovered the preparedness market, and that makes it difficult to know where to go and who to trust. MyPatriotSupply.com is owned and operated by patriots just like you, has the best prices on storable food, non-GMO seeds, water filtration devices, home canning equipment, survival and self-reliance books, and more. MyPatriotSupply.com has old-fashioned values and the absolute best customer service in the industry. Look for the deal of the day, unique, affordable survival supplies that fit anyone's budget. Get same-day shipping on all orders and free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927, 866-229-0927, or visit MyPatriotSupply.com for emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence. Shop with a name you know and a name you can trust. Before it's time to survive, it's time to prepare. MyPatriotSupply.com.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, filling in for Alex. Alex will be joining us at the bottom of the hour. He's going to be giving us live reports from London. They're covering Bilderberg. Now, there was a meeting yesterday that was covered by Charlie Skelton with The Guardian, and he was talking about the odd mix of people with local concerns and international journalists who are looking at a much larger picture. One of the things that came out of that that Alex has talked about as well from his sources was that they've been planning this for 18 months. 18 months. But of course, we hear even from some other Bilderberg attendees that they didn't know until the very last minute. It was called, and get this, Operation Discuss. That's D-I-S-C-U-S-S. Although we would think it was Operation Disgust, as in disgusting. They've been running that for 18 months. And of course, they have to be very, very secretive about this because of terrorism. Terrorism. Was terrorism an issue for the last 60 years? It's now the excuse for everything the government does. Of course, the government needs to keep all information hidden from us. There can be no transparency in government. We have to come after whistleblowers with an iron fist. Why? Because of terrorism. We have to put our hands down your pants at the airport because why? Terrorism. But what have we achieved from this for the last 60 years? We had, just before the break, we had Andrew Kakabadze talking about the fact that they were secretive because they were doing this for our own good. They were coming together to get world peace. And yet, for the last 60 years, we've had nothing but continuous warfare. Warfare that benefits the military-industrial complex, the bankers, and the politicians who are primarily the attendees at these Bilderberg meetings. Doesn't really work out too good for us there. Have you got a little bit more of that, Andrew Kakabadze? Could you pull that up from where we were listening to it? Because he had a few more things to talk about there that I thought were very interesting. But we're going to have Alex in just a few minutes from London. Meanwhile, in Europe and around the world, people are rejecting Monsanto's GMO products. And there's concern because we just had this Supreme Court decision last week, or perhaps 2 weeks ago, where it was unanimous in the Supreme Court that Monsanto could patent their genes and could enforce this on other farmers, even if it came into their field and cross-contaminated their own seeds that were non-GMO. Monsanto could come after them as if they had planted and infringed on their copyrighted genes. And we've now had a situation where exactly that has happened. And as a result, several Asian countries as well as European countries are banning wheat that's produced in the United States because they're concerned about contamination from GMO products in Monsanto. Isn't it interesting that GMO products, as well as fluoride, are not allowed in Europe and in many places in South America? And in India, they basically ran Monsanto out because so many farmers there were committing suicide. Monsanto was doing the same thing to them that they are trying to do, which they were successful in doing in this Supreme Court decision that happened. And that is coming in and doing a test and saying, there's some strains of our product in your crop, and then charging the farmers in India. Of course, these are poor farmers, and they were running them out of business by the thousands, and they were committing suicide. A very large number of them committed suicide. So to protect the food supply, even to protect the predatory business practices of Monsanto, it's been banned in many areas of the world. And yet, in America, they get a Supreme Court decision that is totally unanimous. You can see the same thing happening with fluoride. All of these European health ministers have said, we are not going to allow fluoride in the water. And yet, in America, we get it in massive doses. You have to ask yourself, what is the matter with America? It seems like we're kind of the target for the globalist elite to dumb us down and to take our money and to transfer our wealth to China. And that's what we've seen for the last 60 years. You have that clip from Andrew Kakabadze up? Can we pull that up a little bit, or we're still working on that, still trying to find it? Okay, let's play it from where we were, or you can back it up just a little bit.
Invitation-only people attending. In another sense, it's probably one of the most influential bodies in the world. Established 1954, European and American interests. The people who are involved in conspiracy theory thinking think it was there to generate wealth. It wasn't. It was there to prevent war. After the Second World War, fundamentally, the elite of Europe and the US wanted to ensure that the world would never have anything like it again. So it started in many ways for good reasons. In all that, there was also a protection of existing
wealth. They
were
very well intentioned. They did it for our good.
It was not just conspiratorial.
Now, you see what's happening here. Pause it there, and we'll pick that up after the break if we've got time. But what's happening here, they can no longer keep it secret. So now what you're going to see is they're going to try to spin this in a positive way. They were just meeting in secret for our own
good.
We're
on the march. The Empire's
we'll be right
on
back.
Run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Now that we have moved into the winter season, there is an increased need to support our immunity and health. At Silver Lungs, we are committed to meeting your needs by providing a full selection of silver-based products. Our most popular silver-based products are the 32-ounce Nano Silver Solutions, our 2-ounce Nano Silver Nasal Applicators, as well as our all-natural silver soaps. Just released is our 100% natural silver gel. Our new silver gel is not based on synthetic gelling agents, which quickly evaporate and leave the silver at the surface. But rather, we have formulated our silver gel using the natural skin nourishing chemistry of aloe vera to quickly penetrate and nourish the skin while delivering the silver more effectively. Visit www.silverlungs.com and click on our store page to find what silver-based products are best for you. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Now is the perfect time to spring clean your body with Supernatural Silver, a non-toxic disinfectant for the body that can be used internally or externally. It helps the immune system by killing the bacteria, viruses, and mold that cause disease. This helps to reduce the workload of your already overworked immune system and allows the immune system to refocus its energy and recharge. Supernatural Silver can help combat over 300 different conditions, and it has the ability to kill over 143 types of bacteria, viruses, mold, and yeast. Supernatural Silver's patented technology includes advanced scientific research with over 180 scientific studies conducted at independent universities, hospitals, research institutions, and nursing homes. To see how Supernatural Silver can change your life, go to supernaturalsilver.com. Use the promo code SILVER2013 for 20% off and like us on Facebook.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic. It's Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, live here in Austin, and coming up live from London is Alex Jones. He'll be joining us in just a few minutes. But we've got a video here that we were listening to just before the break from Andrew Kakabadze, and he's part of the friendly face now that is coming out for Bilderberg. They're going to be a little bit more open, and they're trying to explain how this group that was vehemently denied by the mainstream even existed until just a few years ago, for decades have been meeting in secrecy. After Jim Tucker started covering them, they vehemently denied that they existed. They poked fun at anybody who said they existed, called them a conspiracy theorist. But of course now they were just operating for our own good. And here's what Andrew Kakabadze says about that. Let's continue on.
In one sense, all it is a conference of invitation-only people attending. In another sense, it's probably one of the most influential bodies in the world. Established 1954, European and American interests. The people who were involved in conspiracy theory thinking think it was there to generate wealth. It wasn't. It was there to prevent war. After the Second World War, fundamentally, the elite of Europe and the US wanted to ensure that the world would never have anything like it again. So it started in many ways for good reasons. In all that, there was also a protection of existing wealth. But it was not just conspiratorial, it was actually for social benefit originally.
Pause it right there. Yeah, there was also some financial benefit. You know, like Prince Bernhard, one of the founders of that, a former Nazi, also was involved in huge scandals of influence peddling in the defense ministries. Yeah, there was some, those kind of things just kind of go back and forth. You know, they're keeping us free while we pay large amounts of money to the military-industrial complex. Just think back to when we were hurling cruise missiles at several million dollars apiece at Gaddafi in the desert and blowing up his tents. That really wasn't working out to anybody's benefit except for the military-industrial complex that was going to rebuild and resupply cruise missiles to the United States government. I mean, how many times can you spend millions, perhaps, I don't know how many millions of dollars the cruise missiles were at the time. How many times can you do that, just blowing up tents in a desert? I mean, talk about asymmetrical warfare. That's amazing. Play a little bit more of this clip.
Well, you've got about 120 people whom any terrorist would like to attack. So the secrecy here is largely because of the security, because you have some of the best brains in the world meeting. You have finance directors.
Okay, so they've got to keep it secret because they've got all these people meeting there. Well, they have G8 conferences, they have G20 conferences, where they have the heads of state of 8 countries or 20 countries that are meeting, and they're not secretive about it like this. This is nothing but rampant influence peddling and lobbying going on here. And we can also see, though, that they have a globalist eugenicist agenda from their meetings that have been leaked from 1955. We see that they were planning the EU and the European Union. They want a massive consolidation of a world government, and that's what these people are about here. We've got, do we have Alex on the connection yet? Okay. They're still trying to establish connection there. They're having a little bit of trouble with their mobile connections. But Alex was caught on an interview as he was leaving at the airport. He did a phone interview with Press TV talking about Aaron Schwartz. And this is really interesting right now because we've got a lot breaking with whistleblowers. A lot of people are seeing crime and corruption. And we've got in the case of Aaron Schwartz, although he wasn't a whistleblower who worked for the government, he certainly understood the issues of cybersecurity. And because of his understanding of cybersecurity, he was very, very effective at opposing CISPA. And it wasn't long after he died that they tried to push it again. He had already defeated it, and he had talked about defeating it, and he was a bull-nosed activist. He was not the person, I believe, and neither does Alex believe, that he was the person that they're trying to make him out to be, that he was concerned about a 35-year prison sentence, really trumped up federal charges out of a very minor thing that was done. He was not so concerned about that he took his life. We really don't believe that. Let's listen to Alex Jones, a little bit of Alex Jones' interview with Press TV.
Almost 5 months have passed since American Internet Freedom activist Aaron Schwartz was found hanged in his New York apartment. Now his fiancée says he was far from being depressed in the days leading up to his suspicious death. In an interview with the British weekly The Observer, Taryn Steinbrückner Hoffman says Schwartz had proposed to her only a month before his death. Hoffman said Schwartz had always been ambiguous about marriage during their 18-month relationship. In the immediate aftermath of his death, Hoffman decried that she called an unfair prosecution that had brought intolerable pressure on the man she loved. Schwartz was facing a criminal trial for alleged computer fraud and downloading millions of academic material. For this, Schwartz was expected to be sentenced to pay several million dollars in fines and up to 35 years in prison. Schwartz was a critic of U.S. President Barack Obama's so-called kill list. In an interview with Russia Today, he had even criticized the U.S. and Israel for their cyber warfare against Iran. Well, Infowars.com's Alex Jones joins us from Austin to discuss this further. Mr. Jones, thank you very much for joining us here on Press TV. Now, it is a known fact that Schwartz was a critic of the Obama government, of the American policies, as well as specifically the kill list, and suspicion still surrounds his death. What do you make of it, first of all?
Well, he was openly saying, and excuse me, I'm in an airport right now. He was openly saying that he was going to fight the charges. They were fraudulent. He was going to beat them. And so I believe that they probably actually killed him, not that they harassed him until he committed suicide. They could hang me in my home and say that I committed suicide. This is a very dangerous precedent. One of the friends, one of the supposed Boston bombing patsies, who said that he thought it was the government doing it, he was shot in the top of the head by the FBI during an interrogation. So in America now, you don't get a judge or a jury or a trial. The FBI just drops by and hangs you or shoots you in the top of the head. And there's no doubt. I know people that know Schwartz. I know people that are off record talking to me about the Boston bombing brothers as well. And there is no doubt from their research that this entire thing is a staged event.
Right. Now, earlier in May, a court in the U.S. sided with the prosecution in keeping evidence secret with regards to the case against Schwartz that was about illegally downloading information from MIT and other networks, so to speak. It raises the question over what is it that they want to hide?
Well, Aaron Schwartz was facing 35 years in prison for downloading stuff basically on the MIT library. Most of this stuff was 30, 40, 50 years old. They were persecuting him because he led the real effective grassroots movements for internet freedom here in the United States. And he was against the big corporations that are setting up kind of a corporatocracy here. In the words of even CNN News, that's CBS News, Chinese style or communist style or Russian style net censorship. So what happened was he was against government web censorship, and so they basically harassed him and hounded him and charged him for 35 years in jail for something that would be like jaywalking, walking across the street, and then said he committed suicide. But I don't buy that. I have known Pulitzer Prize winners like Gary Webb, who exposed CIA drug dealing, who told me he was being followed and that he had a big book coming out and that he was shot twice in the head. So it's beyond them harassing him, in my view, in my research, until he committed suicide. I believe that clandestine forces, may have even been corporate forces, that want this $100 billion a year cybersecurity spy grid killed Aaron Schwartz.
And Mr. Jones, very quickly, if you can, right now we're going to see the trial of Bradley Manning starting soon as well. This is a time when many are asking questions over what is the future of people like Schwartz in the U.S.?
Well, their future is death, unless we all stand together. I mean, we have mainline reporters that do interviews with people from the State Department on just issues like North Korea. It's not even secret information, and they're being arrested, the State Department people, the journalists. So this is a persecution against real media and against the conscience of America. America is full of moral good people, but we've been very, very naive about how corrupt the globalists are. And so now that people are waking up, they're trying to persecute the press and whistleblowers. So there is a war going on against truth tellers and people that have conscience in America. But I'll say this in closing. I believe the persecution of whistleblowers, I believe the persecution of whistleblowers, the persecution of government people, the persecution of media has now backfired.
Okay.
And people have got past their fear. You're going to see a lot more whistleblowers.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it there. That was Infowars.com's Alex Jones joining us from Austin. Many thanks indeed for your comments here on Press TV.
That's a great report. Alex is always on point there. Even when he's traveling, he's doing interviews from the airport. And we're going to be having him live in London soon. We're still trying to establish connection there. We lost it momentarily. Now, one of the things he was talking about, clearly he doesn't believe that Aaron Schwartz was this dejected, depressed person, and neither do the people who know him. His fiance said that he had just was very upbeat and had proposed to her for the just recently, just before he supposedly took his life, and they'd been seeing each other for quite some time, and he had not proposed to her in quite some, for this long relationship. So he was clearly looking to a future there. And he was not the kind of person who was going to be bullied and intimidated. He was a fighter. You know, he wasn't as forceful as Alex, but he had a backbone of spine, a spine that he was fighting this. He was someone who took on the government and relished his victories in defeating cybersecurity. Now, at the same time this happened, there was a lot of criticism when people that believed the official government line that he had been bullied by the government into committing suicide. In defense of the prosecutor, Carmen Ortiz, her husband posted on Twitter saying that Schwartz had rejected a plea bargain offer that would have reduced his sentence to only a few months. It was a little over 3 months. He posted that he had rejected that. That sounded like the Aaron Schwartz that we know. That sounded like the fighter. That sounded like the person, excuse me, who wanted to fight this in court and win. And yet, that was taken down shortly after that. Excuse me. This prosecutor, Carmen Ortiz, had just had, at the same time that he Schwartz had committed suicide, just a week prior to that, she had come under withering public criticism for going after a small owner of a hotel. There had been 15 years. They'd had 14 drug busts over 15 years there, and she went after his hotel and tried to confiscate it from him. And she was slapped down hard by an appeals court. And this is something they do in the war on drugs frequently. They go in and they charge the inanimate object, the hotel or the airplane or the automobile, with being an accessory to crime. And because there had been 14 drug busts over a 15-year period, and this is a pretty bad area, and according to all reports, this hotel owner had done everything he could to try to keep the place clean and secure and free of gangs. But she used that as a pretense to go in and try to steal his hotel. And she was shot down by that, got a lot of criticism from that. She was somebody who was on a fast track politically. She had been touted by the governor of Massachusetts as a possible successor. And then within a very short time, this case about the drug war hit and had a lot of backlash publicly. And then there was backlash from the Aaron Schwartz suicide. And so in her defense, her husband posted that he had turned down a plea bargain. But then he mysteriously hangs himself. And we're told that it was out of depression. And like Alex said, we've also seen the FBI go down and get this accessory to the this person who he wasn't an accessory. He was somebody who knew Zokhar Tsarnaev. And they questioned him several times. And they had an FBI agent from Massachusetts come down. And the next thing you know, this guy has been shot in the head, but also shot 6 times in the body. Multiple FBI agents saying that they're doing this out of self-defense. Pretty amazing. But they're not the only ones. We've got Bradley Manning, who's we just had some pictures surface of Bradley Manning looking like a ghost. We're told that from July 2010 to April 2011, he was held in a maximum custody detainee at the Quantico Marine Base in Virginia, where he sat in a fluorescent lit 6x8 foot cell with no window, no natural light for 23 hours a day. Guards checked him every 5 minutes. He was stripped naked at night because authorities deemed the elastic in his underwear could be used to harm himself. Just amazing. Just amazing. When you go back and you look at the history of Kissinger and look at the special report that was on the nightly news on Monday night, look at his involvement in things like Operation Condor in South America. Very few people in America really know what was going on, but it was something that involved not just Chile and Pinochet, but also it involved Argentina, the Dirty War, and it involved many other countries in South America as well. It went up to Brazil, but it was focused primarily in Chile and Argentina. Now, at the time, Kissinger was disavowing any knowledge that he had anything to do with any of this, but in the late 1990s and the early 2000s, we had declassified documents that were released that showed that he knew very much about this. He was very much involved with all this. What has changed, however, is since the 1970s, when Kissinger was doing these sorts of things in secret and denying that he was doing it, now the Obama administration tortures people openly. They used to use surrogates to do this sort of thing in South America and other places. Now they do it openly, unashamedly. They assassinate, they torture, they use drone kill lists, and they don't apologize for it. Folks, this is going to come back to the U.S. This is not something that is going to stay abroad. We already see DHS arming itself. We know that when the American people tolerate this sort of thing against human beings in other countries, it is going to come back, and it's going to come, these chickens are going to come home to roost in our country as well. On another note, Obamacare, the thing that will not go away as much as we want it to. Remember when they were trying to sell this, and they told us that in the UK, it was working just great, you know, and Canada, everything's working just fine. We need to do exactly what they're doing. Well, the Mail Online reports that hospitals are now going to have to close to save the national health system there from financial ruin. They say that they're predicted to hit a deficit of £54 billion by the year 2022. They say the service is no longer sustainable in its current form. They're calling for transfer of services from hospitals to communities. But of course, this was what we needed to have in our country, we were told. We're already seeing insurance rates go up 146%, and it hasn't even been fully implemented, and it's going to get worse because they're going to say that private system has totally failed and we need to take it over. That's what they're trying to do, is take over a major segment of the economy. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
In the U.S., one in every 50 homes will have a break-in this year. Burglars call it smash and grab. Police call it robbery. We call it avoidable. We are Fake TV, a simple electronic device that can fool even professional burglars. Fake TV easily plugs into any outlet and simulates the changing colors of a television. To a burglar, it looks like someone must be home watching TV, so they'll likely move on to an easier target. At only $29.95, Fake TV costs less than a month of most alarm monitoring plans and comes with free shipping. Order your Fake TV by calling 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to faketv.com. That's 877-532-5388 or faketv.com. Fake TV, the burglar deterrent.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
Don't
call my name out your window.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight filling in for Alex while he is live in London, and he will be joining us live at the top of the hour. We had a little bit of transmission problem there. He was going to be with us a half hour ago, but we have now established contact with him, and he'll be joining us. Now, we want to thank our sponsors who are making this possible, because it is he does have a large crew there. It's expensive to run this operation. We've got Infidel Body Armor is one of our new sponsors. It can stop hundreds of rounds of AK-47, M4, 3060, 308, and more. Pretty amazing. This stuff is very heavy. We've got one right here in the office. You can contact them at 888-608-6605. That's infidelbodyarmor.com. Also, we've got a special going this week while Bilderberg is taking place. It's 15% off of ProPure filters. This is a single filter. It's a very interesting technical redesign of their previous filters. A big advancement, and it's the only single filter that takes out hydrofluorosilicic acid, and that's something that is very important. That's predominantly what they use in fluoride contamination of our water supply that we see, like we see here in Austin. So we got 15% off of that filter. Check that out. You'll see that at InfowarsShop.com. And don't forget that we've got a consolidation of all of our Bilderberg coverage at Infowars.com/B, as in Bilderberg. You'll find reports from us and other people, as well as live reports coming up. And we're going to have several live reports coming up there. Lee Ann McAdoo is there with Alex Jones, as well as Paul Joseph Watson and Steve Watson. And Richard Reeves is there assisting. They've got some interesting stuff coming up, and Alex is going to tell us what they've found out today. Now, in other news, we've got an interesting thing. You know, part of the agenda of Bilderberg is eugenics. And we've seen that it's not just Bilderberg. They're not the only organization. When Andrew Cacabazzi was talking about it, he said, well, you know, there's a lot of different organizations. We've got the Trilateral Commission. We've got the Council on Foreign Relations. Yeah, and they have a tremendous amount of influence. But then we also have other meetings, just like the one that took place just a couple of weeks ago in Kiowa, South Carolina. Bill Gates held a conference there, which is kind of focused on, quote-unquote, health issues. And we know that Bill Gates, coming as he does from a couple of parents who are very connected in Planned Parenthood, he has been coming up with one thing after the other that make us suspicious. Things like vaccinating people by releasing mosquitoes. He's absolutely obsessed with vaccinating everybody on the planet. And places where he's gone in and vaccinated large portions of the population that hadn't been vaccinated before, we see the kind of consequences that you expect from vaccination. But certainly there are other organizations besides Bilderberg. As we shine the light on Bilderberg and they're starting to talk about maybe they're going to have press conferences, maybe they're going to talk to people, maybe they're going to release their agenda, they're concerned about being portrayed as a shadowy group. So they may go a little bit more public. They may disband it completely. They may meet in other areas, as we saw with Bill Gates buying out, as they did at Bilderberg, buying out an entire luxury hotel for the elites to stay there and making sure that nobody else came in, using the security that taxpayers pay for, as well as their own private security. But as part of this eugenics agenda here, large part of that is hard population control. Of course, China's got its one-child policy, and we've seen the disastrous consequences of that there. Now, Myanmar is doing the same thing in their country. They're putting on a two-child policy, which, as Jurian Messin has talked about, Europe has talked about doing the same thing. And it's pretty amazing. They treat children who are born there as if they did not exist. We're going to have more information about that, and we'll be talking to Alex right after the top of the hour. Stay tuned.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome back. I'm David Knight, standing in for Alex Jones. He is live in London, and he's going to be joining us in just a moment. Just before the break, I was talking about Myanmar imposing a population control. Now, they are singling out, this is a little bit different from the China one-child policy. In Myanmar, they are imposing this strictly on a Muslim minority. But it's not just that. Listen to what the policy is. It says these children of this Muslim minority that are born out of wedlock or in a family that already has two children will not receive any status whatsoever from the government. Now, what does that mean? That means they won't get any education. That could be a blessing in disguise. But they won't get any other government services. They're unable to receive travel permission, so they won't be able to get out. And they are later not permitted to marry or to acquire property. They are subject to arbitrary arrest and detention. This is the sort of thing that we all are concerned about seeing when, earlier this week, we had Motorola's mobile division talking about what a terrible imposition it is to have to remember all of your passwords. So we're just going to make that easy for you. If you want to deal with the internet, you're going to have to wear this patch, or you're going to have to swallow this pill. And if you don't opt into things like this, this is the sort of thing, exactly what they're doing, this Muslim minority here, the fact that they cannot travel, they cannot marry, they are subject to arbitrary arrest and detention at any time. Why? Because they were the third child, because they offended this authoritarian government, and Myanmar is a very, very authoritarian government. But this is exactly the sort of thing that we're concerned about happening in this country as our government makes it more and more difficult to do anything without being registered or identified by them. Remember that a huge part of the immigration bill that is up for consideration is biometric identification. Now, of course, they take our fingerprints, they have pictures of us, they have facial recognition. They are taking this to an all new level. And what is different about this is that in the name of saving us from illegal immigrants, they're going to make this biometric identification a prerequisite to getting a job. You see where this is leading? You got to have their ID before you can get a job. You have to have their approval before you'll be able to get onto the internet. Does this sound like the Book of Revelations or what? We're getting very close to something like that, aren't we? Do we have Alex on the line there, guys? Ready to come in? Or? Okay. We're going to have him in just a second. They're still having a little bit of issues with him. Now, one of the other things that's just come up is the top national security post. We've just had a resignation there. And it looks like Tom Donilon, who was the national security advisor, is resigning. And he's going to be replaced by, guess who? Susan Rice. Yeah, this is the person who was essentially touting the story that the Benghazi attack was a reaction to that, wouldn't even call it a C-rate movie. I don't know. It's the most ridiculous, poorly produced movie I've ever seen. I can't believe that it would cause anybody to riot in the streets if you look at that, unless they want their money back from their ticket. It was just amazingly bad film. And Susan Rice and Hillary Clinton were making the talk show rounds telling everybody that was what was behind the Benghazi attacks. Now, we know from other sources have told us that essentially there was internecine fighting going on within the CIA, that this was an area that was arming certain elements of our terrorist co-sponsors that are there. The same people that we're supposedly being protected from were also being armed by the United States government. And we've been told that's what was really behind that, and certainly not a film. But this lady who touted that story is now up for National Security Advisor. We'll be right back with Alex Jones, live from London. Stay tuned.
You prepare by purchasing gold, food, and firearms. But if you don't have a home security system, then you're missing a critical weapon in your arsenal for home protection. When you're sleeping or away from home, who's watching out for intruders? Check out Simply Safe. It's a new do-it-yourself home security system that is completely wireless. Go to GetSimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is independent and off the grid. It runs on battery power, so even if the grid goes down, you're protected. It's completely customizable, so you can use it in your home, business, boat, trailer, storage unit, or shed. Get SimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is also ridiculously easy to install yourself in under 20 minutes, so there's no need to let a stranger into your home. If you move or need to relocate, you can take the system with you wherever you go. You aren't always at home, but Simply Safe will stand guard, protecting your property 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Again, that's GetSimplySafe.com.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
CalBend Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soap that is triple concentrated and made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a free catalog and buy American-made products. Order the sampler, a 1 to 2 month supply, or get a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. You're getting soap products twice as good as what you're using now. This is an amazing deal, and you will love the way real soap makes your skin feel. Call 1-800-340-7091 or visit www.5starsoap.com. Alex and his staff have used these earth-friendly, pure soaps for years. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a catalog.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are broadcasting worldwide from north of London, England, here in Watford. I'm coming to you from our impromptu hotel room, which turned into kind of our press command center with at least five of our reporters here writing stories for Infowars.com. Let me just tell the syndicated radio audience and everyone else what's coming up now that we're into the second hour. David Knight did the first hour. He'll be riding shotgun with me in the second and third hour. And then Jakari Jackson's coming in a fourth hour of overdrive and maybe out beyond that, because it had been my intention today to
to drive in this morning to London and to go show the changing of the guard at Buckingham Palace, complete, you know, just parasitic corruption being worshipped. I was going to also go show the City of London within London, the financial district that is the dominant center of the world of real globalist Rothschild, Rockefeller-type corruption. And then I was going to go to a couple other places, but then BBC Newsnight, the biggest program in the UK, but one of the biggest news programs worldwide. I mean, it's on you know, mainstream television in the US. It's probably one of the biggest news programs in the world, if not the biggest. They wanted to interview me. So I'd already gotten to London, and I was getting ready to do some live feeds there and then come back and cover the beginnings of the Bilderberg meeting tonight that really kicks off tomorrow. When they called and said, please come back, we want to do an in-depth interview with you. And boy, was that a circus. So I'm going to tell you that story. And then I'm going to get into unprecedented media coverage. And they're trying to be snot-nosed about it in U.S. and British and European papers about, okay, Bilderberg exists, but big deal. People that want to cover royalty and heads of corporations and banks meeting in secret to rob you, you know, it's no big deal. So there's a big lobbying scandal in England right now. So what if people are having to resign in the government over stuff like this? So what if Bilderberg attendees have been indicted before at four things they did at Bilderberg concerning ripping off taxpayers and inside deals? You have corporate chiefs meeting with regulators in secret. I mean, this is totally illegal. They've tried to spin that. So we're going to be looking at how they're responding as well today and cover the unprecedented press coverage that is going on right now. But then, in about an hour, I'm going to leave here again, jump on the train, go back into London, and I plan to broadcast live from Big Bend and Parliament. And so in the fourth hour of overdrive, I will be broadcasting from right outside Big Bend. And there's so much free speech in London, the police will probably try to stop me with an iPhone talking into it. Because believe me, they're watching everything we're doing. You can't let slaves get the idea that they could use a phone to go broadcast from the streets of London. But regardless, we're going to do it. That's about 2 hours away. Some stations carry the fourth hour, some don't. But you'll be able to find the free audio and video streams at Infowars.com/show, which is the permanent link, or Infowars.com/Bilderberg for all of the coverage. And my biggest problem getting on air during something like this is that I've got hundreds of points I want to make. I mean, I have got so much breaking news. Kurt Nemo's got an article, Financial Scandal Draws Heat on Bilderberg Secrecy, dealing with indictments and resignations in the government for illegal lobbying and secret meetings, while the ultimate secret meeting that they said didn't exist is going on right now. I met with the highest level government official, government servant, he wants to be called that, who is over Bilderberg liaisoning with the government. And I'll just leave it at that. I basically met with the intelligence services of England. I mean, we'll just leave it at that. And they said Bilderberg is considering doing a press conference Friday or Saturday. They're having an internal debate, and they want this to happen. And Paul Watson put an article out on this morning that is just huge news. And everything was clicking because I talked to two different high-level senatorial aides who said, listen, there are people in the Bilderberg group, we know who they are, they're Peter Thiel and people like that, who want to go public with Bilderberg and that want to, quote, have a free market and know that the New World Order is not going to succeed. And basically, it's the new revolution in Bilderberg, all these young people coming in who aren't like Nazi princes from the Netherlands and folks. Whether they're good or bad, they're playing the part of good cop right now. We don't know if they're good or bad. But I was already told by a senatorial aide and somebody else in the Senate. I'm just going to leave it at that. It wasn't technically right, two senatorial aides, but I'm trying to. The point is, Senate sources. It's so hard keeping track of all these sources and trying to not blow their cover. That they had met with members of the Bilderberg group or people that were members saying, look, we may just go public on this whole deal and the whole global governance program. And then I'm meeting with the head guy or gal, I'm not going to say who. I'm meeting, well, it was a guy and a gal, but the individual in the government, in the British government, who's giving, well, better not say that. The point is I meet with a high-level individual liaisoning and all this, and they confirm what I was told by two Senate connections months ago. And I happened to be at a party that had some of the biggest people in media at it. And they've got their finger on the pulse. They know how popular liberty is right now. They're kind of realizing we can't beat us, join us. But I was invited to a private party a few months ago in Austin, Texas, where some of the biggest people, I don't mean on air, I mean people that run media empires. There's like six big media empires. One of these people is at the top of that. And they said to me, they said, look, Peter Thiel is a great guy, and he likes your show, and he doesn't like what's going on with the New World Order, and he doesn't like the fact that you're saying everybody at Bilderberg's bad. He says he's in there trying to get him to go transparent. And I'm like, yeah, yeah, right. And I was told about somebody else. I'm not going to say their name. And then I'm hearing it from two senators, people that work for him. and then I'm sitting there with British intelligence telling me this. So let me tell you, Paul Watson, last night we're sitting around during this meeting that's off record, and I said, go write that. And he goes, I'm too tired. It's 11 o'clock at night, you know, after we got done meeting. We met them at like 9, and then we had dinner, and it was like 11. And he said, I'll do it in the morning. And then he writes this article. That's Paul's only problem. What we're doing is sensational. So my reporters tend to water down what we're doing because it's so incredible the success we're having, we can't believe it. So he wrote this article. In fact, let me find the headline. My internet is just atrocious here in the kind of countryside of northwest of London. I can't even pull up the article that I had earlier. It's like dead from earlier today. I'm trying to find the exact headline. Can you guys put it up? No, wait. Internet's working now, that Paul Watson put up this morning. Here it is. Insider. Should be insiders. Bilderberg considering press conference. So I don't know if they're going to do it, but I've been told by two senatorial connections, a major media connection, and now British intelligence people. Just leave it at that. You know, these are the guys. Well, I can't say anything. I'll figure out who it is. That indeed they've met with Bilderberg's head of security and with all the spooks inside that were there already there last night. There's helicopters everywhere, you name it, for a meeting that doesn't exist, doesn't matter. And that they are feeling the heat. It's not now that they're seen as avant-garde or they're seen as elusive or they're seen as mysterious or exclusive because they're so secret. Now they're getting that everything they wanted Bilderberg for is working against them. They want you looking at presidents and prime ministers and bureaucrats and no more above that. Because once you actually look at the power structure and go, they're getting taxpayer money, they're getting billions in bailouts, they're lobbying to raise taxes on poor and middle class, it's game over. Once the peasants know there's a castle and a corrupt king in it, if things aren't going well in the kingdom, the king is going to have people with pitchforks coming politically. So this is a huge victory. I was out there with the police. They were being ordered today by Bilderberg security to push us back, and they were arguing with them and refusing and smiling and quietly, when my camera was off, shaking my hands, our hands, and saying, look, we know what's going on. We don't like what's happening. And it wasn't good cop, bad cop. These cops had that energy in their eyes and the little tear in the corner of their eye, like they were burning with liberty, wanting to join us. And it was, you know, real, going, we know, we don't, because people realize they have self-preservation. They realize this is bad for their kids. I was giving speeches about everybody's children out there, and I saw the cops looking at me like really getting it. And I got to tell you, England has its own corruption and problems, but the people have a lot of soul here. That's why they're so repressed. It's because they used to be a bunch of wild, you know, Celts running around. I mean, they are really getting it. In Virginia, the cops were on our side a day or two into it and came over and privately told us, the head cops, that they were listeners and everything. But now it's immediate with the police, where you'll turn your camera off and they'll grab you by the arm and go, we know what's going on. Don't you ever say we're with these people. But I'm like, well, why are you doing it? We'll be fired if we don't, you know, do all of this. But the point is that we have people driving by honking their horns, people stopping on bicycles and motorbikes that are listeners who live in Watford. I rode on the train to London, and a third of the people on the train in front of my crew in London were shaking my hand. Old women, young men, black people, white people, Arabs, everybody. I mean, Richard Reeves was there. It is incredible. And I had listeners coming over going, you don't know how big you are. Everyone in my apartment complex listens to you. You don't know. And again, I'm not bragging, hey, we're big. Hey, we're cool. I'm a movie star. I'm not. It's the opposite. I'm giving you the good report that I am in England, and I was here 7 years ago, and we had 1/10 of the people on the street talk to us. And I don't know where all these listeners are, because our numbers show us about 15 million a week one way or the other. How is 15 million a week, I know we're going to break here, translating into people running over to me from Poland, and people from Russia, and people from South Africa, and people from Germany saying, my whole family listens. This is incredible. The world is awakening. Big breaking Bilderberg news straight ahead on the other side of this break. Stay with us.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
When you need it the most, will your generator, power equipment, or vehicle be ready? Gas and diesel fuels go bad quickly when stored, and more than half of generator failures during disasters occur as a result of expired fuel. PRI fuel stabilizers keep your fuel fresh for when you need it most. Nuclear power stations, emergency service providers, and ships at sea rely on PRI fuel stabilizers. And you can too. Call 888-776-9373 or visit priproducts.com to find the dealer nearest you.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. On placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Great news, pure water lovers. BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com has a special discount offer for all GCN listeners. You can't do better than a Big Berkey for economy. For only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. There's none better than a Big Berkey for emergency preparedness as a backup water source. And you just can't beat a Big Berkey to remove dangerous chlorine, all types of fluoride, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, parasites, and unhealthy byproducts from municipal water. Berkey water filter systems are even powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. For the gold standard in water filters, get a Big Berkey at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And all GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. For details, call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
To thank you for being a loyal listener, we have a limited time freebie offer for you. Claim your free heirloom tomato seeds, just pay shipping, right now at 123freeseeds.com. These aren't ordinary seeds. These are heirloom, non-genetically modified super seeds that are open pollinated and can be grown, harvested, and replanted endlessly. These survival seeds are actually more valuable than gold in a crisis. Go to 123freeseeds.com and you can get an airtight storage packet of 150 super seeds free while supplies last to say thank you for being a loyal listener. First come, first served. Just cover shipping. Go to 123freeseeds.com now to see if your free heirloom seeds are still available. That's 123freeseeds.com.
long, lonesome highway east of Omaha.
It's hard to cut off Metallica's rendition of it. The song continues that, you know, you don't ever fight back because you feel like you're outnumbered. And the globalists want you to feel like you're outnumbered, but you're not outnumbered. And that's why I'm telling you this. And let me tell you something. The protests and demonstrations haven't even begun. We probably had about 50 people out there today that just spontaneously showed up when I happened to go over there for about an hour. Outside the Grove Hotel, and every 20th car or so would drive by and honk and say, Alex Jones. And then people were stopping on bicycles, and I'd go, do you live around here? Yeah. Guys on motorcycles, yeah, I live in this town. I'm a listener. We all listen. And then I was on the train, and people would say, you're Alex Jones, you're Alex Jones. And I listen. It wasn't just from the Piers Morgan thing that was aired on all the TV over here. And again, that's a good message. People know about the New World Order. If some, you know, egg-headed, you know, guy like me can have all these listeners and viewers, I don't know how it's so massive. That shows that we're not all alone. Richard Reeves is here. Reluctantly, he's coming on the air. Reeves, tell folks what you've seen here.
All right, folks. Absolutely. Everywhere Alex goes, he's more and more recognized. And I'll tell you why, Alex. The reason is because you know how to articulate and explain and reveal the New World Order to the public. That is the key. Even the police, you're able to deprogram, and even as heavily as they're programmed, Alex has the message to break through. So that's it. I've been running around with Alex doing these different remotes since, I think, around 2007. And I remember one night in Manhattan that we were there during a 9/11 event, and a guy just out of the blue that didn't even know that Alex was in town for events happened to run it and see Alex and hear Alex and say, hello, I recognize you, I've seen your videos. And now more and more as time goes by, that exact same thing happens. They hear Alex's voice first. They can hear him talking. They can hear him talking about the groom of the stool needs to return to work with the queen. And all of a sudden they say, Alex Jones, I recognize that voice. I hear you. I've seen your videos. What a pleasure and honor to meet you.
Tell folks what happened today on the train.
Well, on the train, it was just over
and
over.
In London at that restaurant.
Absolutely. Everywhere we go, there's people that recognize the New World Order and know about the New World Order.
Yeah, but it was like a third of the people on the train.
Absolutely. Absolutely. About a third of the people. And it's just amazing. It's great. Pretty soon, it'll be half the people. Pretty soon, it'll be 75 or 80% of the people. So, New World Order, you're in trouble. You guys, you're going to have to keep your steel cages around you, whether you're at the Grove or wherever you're at. The people are going to know about you. You're going to be the prisoners on this planet instead of us being the prisoners of the planet.
I mean, I got to say, though, and we got to have somebody explain this mystery to us, because I look at our numbers, and we have, you know, like a million visitors a day on average to both the websites, and 3 million or so on the radio and YouTube and everything. You got to go about 50 million a week, one way or another, listen, individuals. If you count, you know, 15 million coming back over and over again, it's like 30-something million a week. But that's what we can track. I don't know how 15 million people a week turns into. And again, I keep marveling at this on air, because we get on the train and there's this old Italian woman, but you know, she spoke with a perfect British accent, but she told me her last name, a pretty Italian name. I won't say it.
Right.
Yeah, her name was Desiree, but the last name was so cool. Don't say it on air. The point is, and then the guy next to us, and then this lady, and they're all Alex Jones. And I'm like, you listen? Oh, we all listen. And I mean, it was more than a third on that train. And on the way back, it turns out, you're Alex Jones, you're Alex Jones. And it was just like, what, in England now? Again, I'm going to come back and cover news when we come back. But the news here, ladies and gentlemen, is that I'm just one little composite of the larger composite eye of awareness of all of us around the world, the consciousness of liberty, seeing the world, seeing justice. I'm just one guy. I'm a humble guy. I don't want to be on air. I'd like to run off and be a recluse. That's what I'm really like. I'm here, and I cannot believe this many people are awake. I mean, we're close to victory, and they're spying on everything with the NSA and Google. They know the answers that I don't know, how big the audience really is. And I don't know how this is happening, but let me tell you, it's amazing. Dave and I, we're going out to break, but what is your take on this good news?
Well, Alex, I think people can instinctively hear what you're doing. I know from working here that you're passionate about this, and that transparently comes through. I mean, you're really concerned about getting the word out. You've got a genuine concern about these eugenics types of things that we see happening. You don't want to see people get enslaved and bullied. You hate that. And that comes through.
But it says the awakening is huge. I'm embarrassed. People are more awake in England, and there's more of a, their eyes are more connected. This is what it was like growing up in Texas. These people are connected. They're smart. Everybody talks about how dumb Brits are. I mean, these people are awake. This Christian lady on the train was reading a C.S. Lewis book, and one lady didn't even know who I was since he was fasting.
The Empire's on the run. We'll be right back. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even if I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
Now is the perfect time to spring clean your body with Supernatural Silver, a non-toxic disinfectant for the body that can be used internally or externally. It helps the immune system by killing the bacteria, viruses, and mold that cause disease. This helps to reduce the workload of your already overworked immune system and allows the immune system to refocus its energy and recharge. Supernatural Silver can help combat over 300 different conditions, and it has the ability to kill over 143 types of bacteria, viruses, mold, and yeast. Supernatural Silver's patented technology includes advanced scientific research with over 180 scientific studies conducted at independent universities, hospitals, research institutions, and nursing homes. To see how Supernatural Silver can change your life, go to supernaturalsilver.com. Use the promo code SILVER2013 for 20% off and like us on Facebook.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hundreds of years before the dawn of history lived a strange race of people, the Druids. No one knows who they were or what they were doing. Remains hewn into the living rock.
Oh, the little Stonehenges.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Stonehenge, where the demons dwell, where the fantasies live and they do.
tonight. A little bit of music from the legendary Spinal Tap. I have been told by a major rock star who knows the filmmakers that that is based on a real band, an American band of all. It's actually Aerosmith. And that it's basically true. I mean, a lot of it is actually written into there as a big joke. I actually know Mr. Perry of Aerosmith. Nice folks. Side issue, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here with Steve Watson, who you know writes for the last 11 years. I was brother for 11 years, you for 10, for Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And it was very nice to meet your Fräulein. Because last time I was here 7 years ago, or you were in the Texas, I hadn't met your girlfriend. She's very nice. And we're here. We've got David Knight riding shotgun. He'll do the third hour today covering news, the scandals, all of the latest information. But at the same time, we're then going to get into London and broadcast in a fourth hour from out on the bridge or close to Big Ben. Some really great scenic shots for you out there. We're going to march around London give you a fourth hour there as well. There is a ton of audio and video and photos up at Twitter, at Real Alex Jones, all of that. But here's the big bottom line. Bilderberg didn't want to be identified to exist because there's nothing about presidents and prime ministers. They don't want to be scrutinized. And now that we forced this out into the mainstream dinosaur media because it made them so non-pertinent, they didn't even count anymore. They didn't even, what's the term I'm looking for, where they weren't even in the game anymore because they were denying this existed while the real media, Infowars.com, DrudgeReport.com, even 5-6 years ago, London Guardian, here in the UK, American Free Press, and others were covering it. They were saying there are no smoking rooms, there's not royalty and rich people meeting. It's crazy to think elites want to control the government to shut down their competition and get taxpayer money. Elites never do that. And bears don't live in the woods either. They don't do other things in the woods either. And grizzly bears don't eat salmon. It's a conspiracy theory. And so by just denying, they've discredited themselves. And so I'm out there. I want to tell the story. We're going to go to Steve and get David Knight's take on this. And I'm in London. I'm about to do all this live streaming from London. And the BBC says, it's totally, what was her name? Zoe something? She's a Newsnight presenter. It's like one of the biggest shows in the world. And she says, I will have fair questions for you, and it's going to be completely reasonable. And we just want to get your take on this. So can you please get back on the train that takes like 30 minutes and come back to Watford and then drive out to the Grove? So I said, okay, I'll come. I show up. The police had said, you're allowed to come to this protest area. This is where interviews are. So I show up there and they go, well, now the Grove says you can't be here. Private security, literally in disheveled outfits with pot bellies, came over and commanded the police. The police begrudgingly did what they were told. They said, well, now you got to move over there. I promise you only have to move over there, and then we'll stop. And I go, I know how this works. Then it'll be move over there. So they move us, all on live streams, like 100 yards down. And then the police are really getting irritated because they're being told to do this. And the BBC lady starts going, so you imagine they're having a meeting. And you were there. You can talk about it in a minute. And I'm like, well, no, this meeting's real. You're a conspiracy theorist. And I went, well, at least we now have them admitting this meeting's happening. Who says there's a meeting? Why do you think there's one? And I go, well, look, there's the police. There's helicopters above. This is where the globalists are meeting. They are meeting. And why are you being conspiracy theorists believing that? And I went, what, you're trying to make me mad? And I went, so I laughed at her. And at the end of the interview, she goes, yes, I was trying to bait you. Well, you were a witness. Well, the exact word was, what'd she say? What was the exact word, Steve Watson of PrisonPlanet.com?
I can't remember what the exact word was, but she was there. She admitted that it was
Get up on the mic.
She admitted it was her role to basically make Alex shout and rave so that they could use a soundbite on Newsnight this evening.
And again, we have the video clip. It's going to pop in my mind in a minute. Paul's upstairs right above us, the room above us, trying to upload it to YouTube. So maybe if that gets up on his channel or my channel, not sure which one he's uploading all these clips to, we can play that in the next hour because that's really important. She says something like, "I was trying to antagonize you. She's I'm trying to make you angry." She didn't really succeed.
She basically just wanted Alex to repeat his Piers Morgan rant, which...
Maybe I should have done that because it would have backfired. People are angry.
Well, a lot of people...
See, I wasn't thinking in a manipulative way. I was trying to go, you know, there's a lobbying scandal. They're in their meeting secret. They've been indicted before for criminal lobbying. Lockheed Martin in the 77. You know, we're just trying to cover this. Why are taxpayers paying for it?
But why are you imagining the meeting? It doesn't exist, Alex. And she's like, I'm just trying to make you angry. I was just baiting you.
Yeah, she was just... Alex was running through the facts, and she was just basically trying to make him rant and rave and sound like a lunatic so they could use that on their nightly news program. And then she went up to, there's a few protesters there already, but there aren't a lot there yet. There'll be a lot more there tomorrow. But she went up to the people that were there, sought out the most sort of disheveled looking protesters that were there. And
yeah, they found one hippie that looks like Gandalf out of about 50 people, and he'll be on tonight.
There were plenty of people there that we were speaking to that were, you know, very
suits and ties, professors,
eloquent
Cambridge professors
that looked, you know, like normal everyday people. But she sought out the most weird looking protester that she could and asked to interview him. The guy could barely even speak, so they'll probably edit that together with a clip of Alex shouting and say, oh, this is all, you know, silliness about nothing. Which is, you know, that's what they've been sent there to do. That's the way they operate. She looked like she didn't want to be there. She was very stern-faced. She wouldn't speak to any of us in any capacity, really, other than, you know, just to do the job that she was sent to do.
Hey, Alex, can I interject something here?
Police don't really know what they're doing.
Yeah, David Knight's going to make a point. You can't hear it. We need to get you some headphones, but... David Knight, make your point.
You know, as I'm listening to this, people are smart enough to understand how they've been manipulated by the media. You know, what you're describing about with this BBC reporter is what people have seen over and over again from the media. And you can see that even when there's not somebody like you pointing it out. You know, for years and years, decades, we had just three major networks here, four if you count NPR. But they were pretty much controlling the media. They were pretty much all reading off of the same script. We knew there was something wrong. We didn't know exactly what the truth was. We get little glimmers and pieces of it, but it's exactly what you're talking about. And what's making this really spread is the fact that people are hungry for authentic news that's not filtered, that's not spun, and that's not what they're getting from the BBC. It's not what they're getting from the mainstream media here. And I think the way you're describing the way they're trying to manipulate this by selectively picking who they want to show, trying to make you angry to get a sound bite. That's exactly what we've seen from the media for such a long time. If people are so sick and tired of being manipulated by the press and by the government.
No, exactly. It's not that Infowars.com is even that good. We're just regular folks sick of this crap trying to build a media operation. It's that they're playing the same old tricks over and over again. Mm-hmm. You can't hear him, but David Knight's bringing up the point of people have seen these tricks in the media anymore. That's why they're losing their entire audience. And then it's kind of sad that we're the best there is. We're not superstars in the info war because we're that great. It's because everybody else is sitting there with their thumbs up their, you know what. Steve Watson, your take on that?
Well, yeah. I mean, no one is gonna seriously get any information out of this BBC report. They're going to get the information from the reports that we're uploading, and that there are some other activists there that are, you know, there's a lot of them uploading videos constantly and streaming, live streaming. That's where people are going to get their information from about Bilderberg. There are no other mainstream media there at the moment. So, you know, where are they? There's a massive, giant steel fence that's been put up around
at taxpayer expense.
Yeah, around the entire perimeter. There are hundreds of police there, and yet they're telling us that there's nothing going on. It doesn't exist. So
she said that over and over again.
Yeah, because she wanted a soundbite.
There's no meeting.
Why do you think there's a meeting? Because there's a huge security
operation. Helicopters and police.
Yeah, police helicopters buzzing overhead. The police started...
Well, they play this mind game. It's like people are sick of playing it.
Yeah, people see right through it. And the police, The police don't know what they're doing yet. I spoke to a police officer. I was being nice to him. I asked him if he was there all weekend. He said he was. And I said, so what, are you going to be like at the front here at the gates all weekend? And he said, I don't know. I haven't been given any orders yet. And he kept going, can you move back, please? And I was going, where do you want me to move to? He's like, I don't know. Just move. So they don't know what they're doing yet because they're taking their orders from the private security
people. You'd have a private security car pull up, and I'm not knocking people with a potbelly. I got one. But like some 20-year-old potbelly would get out and go with a shirt hanging out and go, move them, move them. And then we're like on this public sidewalk. People are walking their dogs, and the cops are saying, you can't walk your dog. And it's just like
yeah, there was a couple, when we pulled up to the front gate, there was a couple of private security guys there who looked about, they were probably about 19 or something like that, and they really panicked when they saw you because they knew who you were. They'd clearly been told to watch out for this guy arriving. They were straight on the radio. It was like, oh my God, he's here. What are we going to do? And then loads more sort of private security people came down, and eventually somebody obviously got wind that we were there, that you were there, and a few other protesters turned up, and that's when the police came down.
And when the police were marching up the hill, because there's like a hill going down to a valley and then up to the hill with a hotel, the police were marching up like they had to face Godzilla or something. And then once they figured out it was just people going, hey, bankers are meeting, they're going to... It's just so ridiculous that they've spun all this. Well, Steve, great job. Go get Paul and the rest of the crew ready so we can get the train into London for a 4-hour of overdrive. Because I'm going to finish up with some news, but great job. Anything else you'd like to add?
No, just that people should come along to the meeting, and we can, if we get a lot of numbers there, then we can, get some information out there and make this, a big thing. Because at the moment, we're just, there's not a lot of people there at the moment, so we just need to get everyone.
Well, sure, it doesn't even kick off till tomorrow. It'll be big tomorrow, probably 500, 1,000 Friday, 3,000-4,000 Saturday, I'm guessing. And then Sunday it'll taper off. This is huge. This is going to be, the fact that they're admitting it exists, now we can have a debate about it. I mean, this is the end. I mean, this is the beginning of the end. Yep. Thank you, Steve Watson.
Thank you. See you soon.
All right, there is Steve Watson. I'm not making jokes or anything. That's always positive. But Steve, great job.
By the way, I brought you a cup of English breakfast.
He brought me a cup of English breakfast tea. That's very important. That's a religious sacrament around here. You get energized like Stonehenge from this. David Knight is with us. But folks, we don't tend to hype things up as our problem. I have talked to people in the Senate, and then I was at dinner with this big media executive, the head of a major media company, that I was invited to another party, and then these people were there. It turned out I was invited because they were there, and they wanted to talk to me. And it wasn't the old co-op me, hey, shut up, we'll give you a job. It was, hey, we talked to these Bilderberg attendees, and they're sick of it all, too, and they're thinking about going public. Now, whether that happens this year or not, there is a debate in Bilderberg of that happening, because I was speaking to one of the top people involved in the British government with security liaisoning with Bilderberg, who said, I've met with their head people, their spokesman, they're thinking about a press conference. How will you respond to a press conference, and what are your ideas they want to know? So it's a dialogue directly with Bilderberg. And I said, well, I don't expect them to march up to the demonstrators and everybody, because they don't control that. They're control freaks. But I think they should come to the alternative media or whoever's in the media area and take maybe 10 representatives of the media up to the garden at the hotel that has all the transhumanist stuff and do a press conference Friday or Saturday, because that's what they were saying. And so Bilderberg is like now trying to reach out to us. Now I realize that, like first senators' offices, then media, and now the intelligence agency, the domestic intelligence agency of the UK. MI5, basically, meeting with us, saying Bilderberg may want a dialogue. What do you think of that? And of course, that's how these globalists operate. They go to the heads of every group, and they try to organize something, and they get the world's looking at them. They get now that they can always control the media. And in the U.S., nobody covers it but Drudge and Infowars. Now, CNBC, and I saw a bunch of other major U.S. news. In fact, that's news right there that I've never seen this morning. In fact, I wrote down notes. I think they're over there, Richard. Of everybody, it was like CNBC and a bunch of other big U.S. news. Because MSNBC isn't big, but CNBC actually has some readers. They were all talking about, you know, Bilderberg and meeting in secret and how this looks terrible. And, you know, Bilderberg needs to be transparent, the CNBC was saying in their headline. And maybe the guys can pull it up and give me the exact headline. But the point is that this is unprecedented. Because they've kept a stonewall that there's no secret government, there's no corruption, the Federal Reserve's not private, there's no New World Order, there's no... And now, again, I keep going back to the fact we're having this debate. So here's some of the articles up at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Financial scandals draw heat on Bilderberg secrecy. Bilderberg 2013, welcome to 1984. Charlie Skelton, London Guardian, has authorized us to post his whole articles. So the Guardian, somebody can post their whole articles. That's great. It's just weird to have them reach out. Like, Guardian says publish our entire articles. So, okay, they're up there. British Bilderberg participant decries group secrecy. You've got in Germany, Britain, and other countries, former attendees are coming out against it. People are getting this New World Order. A lot of them were sold New World Order was going to help everybody. And now they're going, what, we implode the economy on purpose under Agenda 21? And shut down all the competition, and all the libertarians and conservatives have the environmental groups shut them down their businesses and the tax offices. It's not just in the U.S. that the socialist and the collectivist through the globalist shut down businesses. It's also in Europe. So we're going to come back and break this down. This is a huge awakening. This is mega massive. I mean, I'm looking at this. This is a revolution against the shadow government happening.
Hello, this is Ty Bollinger, author of the best-selling book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box. I want you to know some very important information. In 1985, President Ronald Reagan requested that Carnivora be sent directly to the White House at a time when only the president could obtain this world-class healer. Now, 27 years later, Carnivora capsules are used around the world to keep people healthy. Now you can protect yourself and your loved ones in this age of superbugs with 17 naturally occurring compounds that instinctively respond to abnormal cells only without harming a single normal cell. If you want to stay healthy, now's your chance to literally wake up your critical immune cells to attack harmful invaders that don't belong in your body. Call 1-866-VENUS-FLY or order from carnivora.com. That's carnivora.com. That's 1-866-836-8735, 1-866-VENUS-FLY, or visit carnivora.com. Protect your immune system. It's the only one you've got.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
So, a natural disaster strikes, and out goes your power. You risk losing stored food in electric freezers and refrigerators. Your options: lose all that expensive food and medication, fire up a noisy gasoline-powered generator, or switch now to a propane or natural gas-powered refrigerator from Ben's Discount Supply. Ben'sDiscountSupply.com has a complete line of propane-powered refrigerators. Freezers in sizes ranging from a small camper cooler size up to a whopping 21-cubic-foot refrigerator freezer or a 22-cubic-foot deep freezer. In stock and ready to ship anywhere. BensDiscountSupply.com also stocks a full line of solar-powered appliances to get you completely off the grid. Check out BensDiscountSupply.com or call 800-771-7702. That's 800-771-7702. Or click BensDiscountSupply.com for camping, home, or bug-out location. Bank on BensDiscountSupply.com.
No, this is the UK.
A little piece of me, a little piece of you,
a little piece of me
will die.
I did it backwards. A little piece of you, a little piece of me will die for America, will die for the system. A little bit of David Bowie there. Actually, we're playing Little China Girl. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. I'm going to go about 5 minutes the next hour. Then I'm going to throw it to David Knight and Jakari Jackson in that next hour. Then a little bit after that, we'll go live from London in a fourth hour of Overdrive. But it is unprecedented that, again, you've got all these members of German Parliament, British Parliament, former attendees of Bilderberg coming out and saying, this is criminal, this is wrong, what's going on? And a lot of it is people are compartmentalized. When the globalists came to me over the years, they said, look, you're a talented broadcaster. You stop talking about the New World Order and bad-mouthing it. It's meant to feed hungry Africans. It's meant to help the world. Global government is good. You could be a right-winger. Just stop talking about the Federal Reserve and the New World Order. I was giving this speech over and over again. And then it comes out they're going to double the carbon taxes on the third world and kill them under carbon taxes, and even the UN people vote against it. Globalism is really nasty, folks. And its biggest crime is that it doesn't just get taxpayer money. They shut down your competition, their competition, so they can dominate. They ruin societies. There's so much wealth. There's so much technology that we could all be living like kings, but they're artificially suppressing economies. They call that overheating economies. And they're trying to reduce our numbers population-wise. And so many yuppies and trendies go, good, there aren't too many people. You're being targeted too, whether it's true or not that there's too many people. We need to be aware of this. So, and by the way, we've uploaded like 10 videos last hour to my YouTube channel, and to Paul Watson's Prison Planet Live channel. We need to get those up on Infowars.com and at the Bilderberg site on Infowars.com, because I haven't even gotten the BBC stuff up yet because we're streaming. This phone's the one enabled with the data package for us to broadcast on. As soon as this is over, when we're on the train, folks, we're going to be uploading videos aggressively of the BBC lady. I want to find the one on here where she's like, Paul, I can't remember, what was the exact word? She said, I'm trying to make you angry. I'm trying to provoke you. That's it. Tell folks about that, Paul Watson.
Yeah, the BBC arrived shortly after we did at the entrance to the Grove. They wanted to interview Alex. And almost as soon as the interview started, she asked Alex a basic question. Then her first response after that was, but aren't you all conspiracy theorists? Aren't you just a conspiracy theorist?
Aren't you crazy?
Aren't you crazy?
How do you know it exists?
Not what's the agenda, who's participating, what's Bilderberg about, what's its history. Aren't you crazy? And this is supposedly someone who works for the premier news organization in Britain, which every British citizen has to pay about £134 a year just to not get a knock on their door from these thugs for the TV license. It's mandatory, and it goes to the BBC. And this is the caliber of reporter that they send out to a meeting of 140 of the world's most prominent power brokers.
Media. It's globally run media.
But she obviously had orders to just try and make you look stupid so they could get a little soundbite and put it on Newsnight where you're saying, you know, I'm crazy like a fox, because they're not going to use anything else. And she was there to provoke. She admitted afterwards, and we got it on camera.
And she lied to me. She said, I'll have a serious interview. We'll get you info. Because I was like, well, hey, you've got a major lobbying scandal. We need to cover this. Of course, sir, please.
You kept getting into the serious issues. She just completely ignored everything you were saying and said, oh, aren't you crazy? Isn't this just a conspiracy theory?
We'll be back and get David Knight's take on that. A ton of news at Infowars.com on this breaking right now. We're going to have a third hour and a fourth hour today. Infowars.com/Bilderberg.
We are the resistance. You are the resistance.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Introducing Pro One, all of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
By the way, when we covered Bilderberg with just Justin TV and Ustream back in 2011, we had 3.5 million viewers on Justin alone over 3 days. Last year, we only had about 1 million viewers total on those channels after that. So the channel like has like 7 million views or something, the Ustream one, or maybe it's the Justin. The point is, we got a bunch of channels. Just from an hour and a half ago where we did a live stream, we were looking at the numbers during the break. What was it, 66,000? 67,000 people watched one video we did live after the numbers, you know, finally registered. 67,000 just randomly we upload something. Again, that's the future. And I don't know what the establishment's going to do. Paul, how do you see this? Then I want to get McAdoo in here briefly before we come back and have David Knight and Jakari Jackson. Then we're going to get a train. We'll be on the fourth hour of Overdrive. And, of course, tomorrow we're going to be able to cut with live Ustream feeds on the radio while we're there. David and others will be watching, and the crew will be watching. We'll be able to cut like we did last year in Virginia. What is the establishment media where it's all going to be edited, it's all got to be controlled, it's all going to be spun, you know, provoke somebody, get a soundbite? What are they going to do as they lose their power, Paul Watson?
They're going to become increasingly irrelevant, and a good example is The Times did an article a few days ago by a guy called David Aranowicz, which said that Bilderberg was just a, you know, a rich person's plaything. It had no influence whatsoever. The Times has lost 90% of its online readership because of people like that. And that's what's going to happen to the mainstream media. That's what's going to happen to the BBC. If you mess around and you send little idiots who follow their instructions to try and make us look stupid, which was the job of that BBC reporter, whenever somebody said something important, they were talking about the lobbying scandal, etc., they actually moved the microphone down to prevent them from being heard. And then they were talking to other people about issues of no significance. They were more interested in that.
Oh, yeah, they were told what not to cover. And here's the deal. It's not that we're good. I have a low view of myself. It's that they are slitting their own throats, Paul.
Well, precisely, because their viewership keeps going down and ours keeps going up. But I think we've had, I mean, the coverage so far before it's even started has been massive. I think it's, you know, it's the biggest ever in terms of Bilderberg. So we are making some progress. And a lot of the articles that came out, such as the one in the Telegraph, you know, you've had Daily Mail.
Drudge with the Drudge Love.
Drudge Plum, yeah. And, you know, they're giving it the seriousness that it deserves. The likes of the Telegraph who came out about, you know, the taxpayers funding the security. But then the BBC turns up and says, isn't this just all a conspiracy theory, like
she
we're imagining
like,
it?
We have video of it. We're going to upload it. She goes, like, 8 times. Isn't it not real? It doesn't exist. It's a conspiracy. And I was like, why'd you do that? She goes, I'm trying to provoke you. That was the word, provoke.
And she said, oh, isn't it just people meeting in private for a chat and a game of golf? No, they're violating their own House of Commons ministerial code under the code of conduct. They're clearly violating it by not declaring private interest.
They're being arrested right now for stuff like this.
Precisely. And I mean, you know, Bill Gates is going to be there. You've got Peter Sutherland. You've got people involved in the LIBOR scandal, people involved in HSBC drug money laundering.
Deal fixing interest rates low for them and high for us.
But the thing is, Alex, it was the BBC in 1955 that got the documents which showed that Bilderberg planned a single currency, the euro, 40 years before it came into effect.
Yeah, they know that, but it has no power and doesn't exist.
And she knew absolutely nothing. She'd obviously done no research. She was told, go out there, make people look stupid, get the footage, come back, we'll edit it.
All right, here you can see Richard Reeves and the rest of the crew. You can see there's Richard Reeves right there. That's actually Mrs. Watson. And then you've got, I'm joking, that's Lee Ann McAdoo. And you've got Stevie Watson right there, the Stevie Wonder of England. And you've got Richard Milhouse Reeves right there. I'm going to come back and put bookends on this with the illustrious David Knight doing a great job, because I've been listening to the show via the free iPhone app. David, you're doing a great job. Follow us and spread the word about Twitter at Infowars online. There at twitter.com/realAlexJones. Spread the word about Infowars.com/Bilderberg. We're going to come back, put bookends on this, let David Knight and Jakari take over with all the other scandals where they're having Environmental Protection Agency go after conservative companies.
Cal-Ben Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soap that is triple concentrated and made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a free catalog and buy American-made products. Order the sampler, a 1 to 2 month supply, or get a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. You're getting soap products twice as good as what you're using now. This is an amazing deal, and you will love the way real soap makes your skin feel. Call 1-800-340-7091 or visit www.5starsoap.com. Alex and his staff have used these earth-friendly, pure soaps for years. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a catalog.
You prepare by purchasing gold, food, and firearms. But if you don't have a home security system, then you're missing a critical weapon in your arsenal for home protection. When you're sleeping or away from home, who's watching out for intruders? Check out Simply Safe. It's a new do-it-yourself home security system that is completely wireless. Go to GetSimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is independent and off the grid. It runs on battery power, so even if the grid goes down, you're protected. It's completely customizable, so you can use it in your home, business, boat, trailer, storage unit, or shed. Get SimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is also ridiculously easy to install yourself in under 20 minutes, so there's no need to let a stranger into your home. If you move or need to relocate, you can take the system with you wherever you go. You aren't always at home, but Simply Safe will stand guard, protecting your property 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Again, that's GetSimplySafe.com.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center and the heart of the resistance.
and that is the great Stevie Ray Vaughan and Jimmy Vaughan, my good buddy. Back in. You know, I heard right after Jimmy had a heart attack a few months ago that it had happened, and I was so glad that he survived and is doing so good. And it was great hanging out with him just a few days before I came here. He and his great wife, Robin, want to say hi to them and other listeners of the broadcast every day. And just great people who are counting on us to do a good job while we're here in Albion, Britannia, now UK, formerly the UK, now under EU domination. And by the way, we've got some of the Godfrey Bloom and some of the other UKIP people are coming down tomorrow. We've been playing phone tag with Nigel Farage, kind of the Ron Paul of Europe. So that's some of the news that we're going to be covering. If you go to Infowars.com, you can see Bilderberg member Queen Beatrix of the Netherlands on the front page. Again, that's Infowars.com. Please, if you can't be here to demonstrate or can't be here as alternative press to cover things because it really kicks off tomorrow, the fireworks have just started. Please, Twitter and Facebook, everything that we're covering. I wanted to get David Knight's take before I punch out for the rest of the hour and get into London to go into the fourth hour. I wanted to get your take on just the fact that you've got British members of Parliament outside of UKIP going public, German members of Parliament, EU members of Parliament saying, I've been to Bilderberg, it's wrong, it is bad. We are setting policy, it is illegal because of conscience and maybe subconscious fear because you've got a big scandal or people that are involved in secret criminal lobbying going to jail. The awakening that there is corruption, that we have to watch the government, that kind of common sense Americana, what the founding fathers talked about, common sense that came out of the Magna Carta 800 years ago, 1215, it is back. I don't mean 1215 in the morning, folks, the year 1215. People fought and died for every inch of human dignity we've got. And all I'm doing and all we're trying to do is reawaken that common sense so we have a collective future together. By empowering the individual, you empower the collective. You empower the collective against the individual, you destroy humanity. Humanity is the individual. And I love humanity. I'm a fan of humanity. You know, the devil says that in Devil's Advocate. The truth is the devil hates humankind. God is a fan of man. So I wanted to get David Knight's take on that. I mean, I'm not hyping this. This is devastating that the police and MI5 are coming to us saying Bilderberg may do a press conference. They're freaked out. I'd already heard that from senator connections and media moguls. I mean, the power structure gets, wow, we thought we'd implode economies, take over, pose. No one would know who we were in the old media paradigm. We would pose as saviors while we assanguinated the economy. But instead, they're running their operation more and more in plain view. How will they deal with that, David Knight? We're trying to have an open dialogue with the globalists. And I've always said, if we'll have that open dialogue and get the sheeple to care about it, it's game over. Because we have the moral authority. This is history happening. But if history happened, but it didn't make a sound, if the mainstream corporate whores didn't cover it, would people know that a tree fell? David Knight, you're a smart guy. What's your take on this?
Well, I don't know if I got any real insights into it. But, you know, we saw the same thing happening with the Obama administration complaining about the Drudge report, saying that it was hard for them to control the news cycle because Drudge was coming
well, they
in
said,
and a lot of people
we can't
were watching.
Let any of our people, even subdirectors of the State Department, any federal 37th agencies, none of them are allowed to talk to any press now because of Drudge, which was kind of the archetype of real media and of that half of its Drudge problem.
Well, and we also saw as this bombing in Boston was happening, we saw them reacting in real time to things that we were covering. We're pointing out things and discrepancies in their story, showing other pictures. They were reacting to it in real time using CNN.
They had a huge drill with double agents.
Yeah.
And whether they actually did it or not, it was a government operation.
Absolutely. And as we were pointing out stuff.
Killing the FBI agents and killing the witnesses' friends, we said that would come next. Mm-hmm. I mean, they did that. That's a false flag, folks. We caught them. Of course, we can't say off record what we know. In fact, I need to talk to Chris about that. We are in contact. Obviously, you know the family or listeners. And what I think happened is, off record, we're talking to their lawyers and everybody. And again, that's off record, but I can say we're talking to them. And I'm talking to some high-level government people as well who realize now what happened. I shouldn't even be getting into this yet, but I'm allowed to say some of it. For those that don't know, it turns out the brothers were basically listeners that thought it was a big joke and that thought that they'd be recruited by globalist-run Al-Qaeda to set up the New World Order. But just like Lee Harvey Oswald didn't want to be part of that, or McVeigh didn't want to blow up the federal building, so they set him up as the patsy. You don't infiltrate these guys and not have them set you up, but that's an issue that's coming. It's so dangerous, I'm reporting it now because the government actually knows about it. But the family, the living brother, all of them are listeners and want to talk and say that they were set up. So, sorry, go ahead, David.
Well, what you're saying is the reaction to what we're covering. So people are following this stuff. They're getting the news. The news cycle is getting shorter. We first saw, when we started reporting a year ago about the massive purchases of ammunition from DHS, it took them a while to start responding. But they eventually started responding, and we saw pushback from the AP. And now the AP itself is getting stuff pushed against them by the Obama administration. They're investigating the AP and letting them know that they're looking at them. Because we all know that they're watching the AP. They're watching everybody. They're recording everybody's phone conversations. So when they come into the AP and they tell them, we've subpoenaed these records of these reporters over this period of time, that's nothing but intimidation. And then we see, just within the last couple of days, we see the AP going in and actually now doing an investigation of this government that we've been told for such a long time by the mainstream media would never consider doing anything illegal or duplicitous.
And see, that's what the founders talked about. They said, bad people will always get into positions of power. How do you block them? Separation of powers. Three branches of government, two branches of Congress, the media, the fifth of state, all pushing each other. And so intimidating the media has now had the opposite effect. It's made them mad where they're now fighting back. And that's what I'm saying, folks. There's always that emergence point where the tyranny comes out of the ocean. The submarine comes up. It's denied that it's there. Now it's there. Now we can have a real debate. We're going to break in a moment. I'm going to throw it to you and Jakari until about 20 after next hour, that we should be down there by Big Ben and all that to do a live transmission with you. But I wanted to bring Lee Ann McAdoo in, doing a great job. Been with us about 3 months, but doing a great job. Get in there on the mic, Lee Ann, and tell folks your take on what you saw today. The awake listeners on the train, the road, but then also down there with the police.
Well, I just think it was so interesting to see how they're kind of corralling the press. So Bilderberg, they are coming out into the public, but they're doing it on their own terms. And the BBC reporter provocateur, she was just infuriating, but I did actually tweet out a video. You can go to it's at Infowars Reports. I tweeted a video. Also, the Ustream channel is Alex Jones Live, if you want to watch us here.
And that's live. All listed at Infowars.com/Bilderberg.
Exactly. So I tweeted up this video where I caught the BBC reporter going up to, you know, the quintessential, you know, sort of crazy looking person with the real, real long hair and sort of meek looking. And she's like, do you mind if I get you on report on here? And he's like, oh, okay. You know, and I called her out and I said, this is the BBC. They're going after the person who's going to make us look the craziest, make us look like we're paranoid. This is a real report here. And she just looked at me like, oh, and she walked away from him.
Did you see where she said, I'm trying to provoke you?
Oh, yeah. She just had this awful smirk on her face.
It's all about manipulating.
As soon as you said, I'm crazy like a fox, she was like, well, I think we've got what we need here. And then walked off. It was awful.
She tried over and over again to make me mad.
Yes.
And lied to get us back to town to say it was a serious interview.
Exactly. She knew what she was going there for. They got their sound bites. But honestly, I think she just wanted the ratings that Piers Morgan got when he had you on the show.
And maybe I should have played the fool, because that only makes people wake up that much more. Nothing they do works. They're a failure. They've sold out against humanity. But how many people do we run into today in London and here in Watford that are listeners?
It was pretty incredible. There was several on the train. People kept coming up to us at the train station, someone at the restaurant, and they were like, are you Alex Jones? Oh my gosh, I saw you. And that was huge what you did here with Piers Morgan, and we watched your show. I think one of the guys was from Bulgaria.
Well, yeah, that was people out there at the thing, though. But on the train, it was like a third of the people on one train, and then it was a bunch on the other, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
But again, that just shows the info's getting out there.
Exactly. It's global. And I think the whole thing with them coming out at this point, because we've forced them to acknowledge that, yes, they do exist,
What do you make of, don't say names, you were at the meeting last night, meeting with the top people saying Bilderberg may go public. What do you want to say to Bilderberg? How should they do it? What did you think of that?
Well, I thought that was pretty interesting, but my gut feeling is that it's either A, dealing, you know, it has to do with the UK lobbying scandal and how, you know, part of their rules of conduct are that they have to be open about their dealings.
Oh, no, that's why it is. They know exactly. They're not nice guys.
Yeah.
They get now this is not going to work anymore.
Right. They don't want to be like Tony Blair, who lied about ever attending
Bilderberg. You're in meetings now with British intelligence. I mean, how weird is that?
Well, that's Steve Lee guy. I don't know.
Well, that's another guy we met with another day, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no. That's the local cop. I'm talking about the people we met with off record yesterday.
I'm just trying to play the new girl. I don't want him thumbing me and getting my facial recognition down.
Yeah,
here.
No, we didn't meet with Steve last night. We went with him during the day and then today. I'm talking about last night we were at that meeting with the other people from Bilderberg. And they were breaking all that down. I mean, you know, saying, well, you know, they are debating going public.
I know. I'm gonna wait and see. I highly doubt they're gonna come to a podium if we set one up for them. You know, I'm sure they'll have the BBC allow them to present themselves to the world. Who knows?
Exactly. All right, folks, we're going to break. David Knight and Jakari Jackson will take it over for the next hour or so into the next hour of Overdrive. If your local stations don't carry it, you'll be able to follow what we're doing. We'll send out the video link at twitter.com/realalexjones or infowars.com/Bilderberg. The Ustreams, the YouTube, the live feeds, it's all there. infowars.com/Bilderberg. Stay with us.
Wouldn't it be nice to have one product that replaces more than 10, saving you space, time, and money? HempUSA.org has a complete full-spectrum vitamin mineral detox formulation called Micro Plant Powder Gold. Micro Plant Powder Gold contains 101 vitamins, minerals, probiotics, and iodine, has a 100-year shelf life, and is a perfect addition to any storage shelter. Make Micro Plant Powder Gold your choice. Call 888-910-4367 or visit HempUSA.org today.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
You prepare by purchasing gold, food, and firearms. But if you don't have a home security system, then you're missing a critical weapon in your arsenal for home protection. When you're sleeping or away from home, who's watching out for intruders? Check out Simply Safe. It's a new do-it-yourself home security system that is completely wireless. Go to GetSimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is independent and off the grid. It runs on battery power, so even if the grid goes down, you're protected. It's completely customizable, so you can use it in your home, business, boat, trailer, storage unit, or shed. Get SimplySafe.com. Simply Safe is also ridiculously easy to install yourself in under 20 minutes, so there's no need to let a stranger into your home. If you move or need to relocate, you can take the system with you wherever you go. You aren't always at home, but Simply Safe will stand guard, protecting your property 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Again, that's GetSimplySafe.com.
Don't throw away leftovers. Instead, throw all your leftovers, vegetable peels, eggshells, coffee grounds, pizza crusts, and more into the Bokashi. If you love to garden and compost but don't like the hassle of turning a compost bin or the smell, then check out the EM Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System from Terraganics. Finally, a way to recycle all your food and plant waste safely and effectively and stop using fertilizers. The EM Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System. Rather than decomposition, the Bokashi system uses fermentation to break down waste, so it takes less time to create nutrient dense humus for crops or gardens with no turning and no obnoxious odors. To learn more and order your Bokashi online, visit Terraganics.com and click on the orange button. That's Terraganics.com, spelled Terraganix.com, or call 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Recycle all your food wastes in about 6 weeks with the Bokashi Food Waste Recycling System from Terraganics.com. Terraganics, life's getting better.
Hello, this is Ty Bollinger, author of the best-selling book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box. I want you to know some very important information. In 1985, President Ronald Reagan requested that carnivora be sent directly to the White House at a time when only the president could obtain this world-class healer. Now, 27 years later, carnivora capsules are used around the world to keep people healthy. Now you can protect yourself and your loved ones in this age of superbugs with 17 naturally occurring compounds that instinctively respond to abnormal cells only without harming a single normal cell. If you want to stay healthy, now's your chance to literally wake up your critical immune cells to attack harmful invaders that don't belong in your body. Call 1-866-VENUS-FLY or order from carnivora.com. That's carnivora.com. That's 1-866-836-8735, 1-866-VENUS-FLY, or visit carnivora.com. Protect your immune system. It's the only one you've got.
Day after day, alone on a hill, the man with the foolish grin is keeping perfectly still.
All right, I'm David Knight, here for Alex Jones. I guess they're trying to, BBC is trying to treat Alex Jones like the fool on the hill, but they got a surprise coming for him. Alex Jones is nobody's fool. Now, we've got a report here. There's a lot of people talking about the IRS, and let's go to this quick clip we've got here of Jay Leno. It's pretty funny. Got that? Cued up, guys.
Obama says he's renewing his efforts to close Guantanamo Bay. Guantanamo Bay? How about closing the IRS? Why don't we do that? Okay. Shipping the IRS to Guantanamo Bay. That's the way. Yes! That's how you do it. Well, more problems with the IRS. A new report has found that they spent $50 million on employee conferences and retreats in just 2 years. They would have investigated sooner, but it turns out, you know, they don't belong to any conservative groups. So nobody really knows. They didn't really see it. Yeah,
yeah. That's great. Yeah, they're kind of acting like the Bilderberg conference, right? They're spending millions of dollars on their conferences. I mean, that's the way this always happens. When you start to see the government getting increasingly corrupt, it starts turning out like Bilderberg. You start seeing them spend $4 or $5 million on an IRS conference. But, you know, it's not just the IRS. It's also the EPA. We've got news breaking today that the EPA is charging for FOIA requests, for Freedom of Information Act requests. And it turns out that in 90% of the cases for liberal groups that are coming into the EPA, they waive the fees, the FOIA fees. But in 90% of the time for conservatives, they charge them fees. And that sounds a lot like the what we just covered last night. Actually, Jakari covered this on the news in more detail. We mentioned it yesterday on the news.
The press shakedown.
Yeah, the shaking down the AP.
Yeah, this is an article, like Dave said, we covered this last night on the nightly news. This was a situation where the AP had a FOIA request to the Labor Department, and they were charged or told that the bill would come to over $1 million, even though it clearly states on the Labor Department's own FOIA request that they cannot charge unless they hit at least 100 photocopies, and then they charge, you know, whatever amount, 10 cents a page or whatever after that. But they said, no, we have to have 2,000 people come in or something like that.
They're going to charge them just for the basic research. I said, we've got to go back and pull this information out. Yeah. Well, they know they've got to comply with FOIA requests if requested. So it's their problem that this stuff is not easy access.
The equivalent, you know, you go to the library and you ask for a book. Well, I'm going to charge you $10 to go find this book for you. That's pretty much what they were doing to the AP. Then they said, oh, well, we really didn't mean that, but we would have took the money had they given it to us.
Well, it's pretty interesting because, like I mentioned with Alex, you saw the AP essentially carrying their water, making some pretty absurd excuses about these DHS ammo purchases. Oh, yeah. And that was something that was, Paul Watson discovered this. He went out and he saw the RFPs. Yeah, and linked to them. So it was something anybody could see. It wasn't like it was a figment of our imagination.
Right.
It wasn't like we were reporting this from anonymous sources or anything. It was right there on the internet. We linked to it in our articles. And yet the AP was coming out with all this stuff about how, you know, that doesn't exist or it's just for target practice, really crazy stuff. But now that the government has attacked the AP, they're coming back and they're actually trying to do some investigation. And now we see this stuff about the FOIA request. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah, it's one of those situations. Just like I said, all this stuff was available free, you know, on the internet. Watson linked to it in all of his articles. And then the first it was, no, we're not buying bullets. And then the excuse was, okay, we're buying it, but then we need it for practice. And then we had people come out and say, well, we want to limit the number of bullets people can buy. And then you had all the criticisms from some of the from the major networks saying, oh, look at these crazy conspiracy theorists. They're trying to limit the number of bullets that administration can buy. But why do they need so many bullets? You know, which is very common sense questions. And you know, as we've pointed out, even we did a report about it. All you have to do is go to a local gun store and they're pretty much out of bullets. Now, it's not so bad as it was, you know, immediately after Sandy Hook. You know, they're starting to get, you know, not just bullets, but also semi-automatic firearms back in there. But it's still a disparity.
Yeah. Well, getting back to the IRS and this EPA thing, I mean, we talked about this yesterday briefly. We've got Ted Cruz, senator, calling for the abolition of the IRS.
Oh, yeah.
You got Jay Leno joking about it, but, I mean, you heard the thunderous applause from the audience. People are ready for this. But it's not just the IRS, as this article points out, it's also the EPA. Mm-hmm. And the EPA has been using a lot of the unconstitutional, illegal, according to the constitutional tactics of the IRS in terms of denying people their due process. And in both these organizations, they're writing their own laws. They've right. got their own court system. Right. And you don't have due process. We have to have some systemic reform here that's not just limited to the IRS. It's got to go across the entire bureaucracy. We're going to be right back. I'm David Knight here with Jakari Jackson. Stay tuned.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Now that we have moved into the winter season, there is an increased need to support our immunity and health. At Silver Lungs, we are committed to meeting your needs by providing a full selection of silver-based products. Our most popular silver-based products are the 32-ounce Nano Silver Solutions, our 2-ounce Nano Silver Nasal Applicators, as well as our all-natural silver soaps. Just released is our 100% natural silver gel. Our new silver gel is not based on synthetic gelling agents, which quickly evaporate and leave the silver at the surface. But rather, we have formulated our silver gel using the natural skin nourishing chemistry of aloe vera to quickly penetrate and nourish the skin while delivering the silver more effectively. Visit www.silverlungs.com and click on our store page to find what silver-based products are best for you. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
Now is the perfect time to spring clean your body with Supernatural Silver, a non-toxic disinfectant for the body that can be used internally or externally. It helps the immune system by killing the bacteria, viruses, and mold that cause disease. This helps to reduce the workload of your already overworked immune system and allows the immune system to refocus its energy and recharge. Supernatural Silver can help combat over 300 different conditions, and it has the ability to kill over over 143 types of bacteria, viruses, mold, and yeast. Supernatural Silver's patented technology includes advanced scientific research with over 180 scientific studies conducted at independent universities, hospitals, research institutions, and nursing homes. To see how Supernatural Silver can change your life, go to supernaturalsilver.com. Use the promo code SILVER2013 for 20% off and like us on Facebook.
I got a star on my car and one on my chest, a gun on my hip and the right to arrest. I'm a guy who's a boss on this highway, so watch out what you're doing when you're driving my way. If you break the law, you'll hear from me. I know I'm working for the state. I'm the highway patrol.
All right, I'm David Knight here with Jakari Jackson, and we're back in Austin. Alex is going to be joining us in the next hour in Overdrive in London. He's going to do a special report going up to Westminster and Big Ben area. I guess they're going to be talking about the amazing parallels between the lobbying scandal that's happening, that's breaking right now in the UK. People crying out for more transparency, more accountability, more openness in government. And at the same time, they've got one of the most closed, secretive, elitist organizations meeting right now in the UK. And they've got both the Chancellor of the Exchequer and the Shadow Chancellor of the Exchequer attending, as well as several members of Parliament. What do you think about that, Jakari?
About this transparency, we are under a current administration here in this country that promised to be one of the most transparent in the history of the United States presidency, and they are the most restrictive censoring, or at least under their administration, journalists have been gone after, even though we saw that nice rhetoric-filled speech from Obama saying, no, I don't want any press to be targeted, but his administration has been doing it, not just recently, since he became president.
Well, it's amazing because you go back and you look at the Nixon scandal. I mean, one of the articles of impeachment about that involved that, using the IRS as enemies, you know, going after the press, and yet things are even more out in the open now. You know, things that they kept secret, things that, you know, Kissinger used to be part of these hidden secret wars, and we got a video coming up that we'll talk about that. But they used to hide with this stuff. Now they do it in plain view, and they do it to a much greater extent than they even did when it was secret. So we've got to get to the point where we get some accountability from government. We got to get government under control. It is totally out of control. And I think even with this AP scandal that's breaking, even the press, which has been an ally of Obama's because of this left-right paradigm, even they're starting to feel the corruption.
Oh, yeah, because before it's, you know, it's like they came for the Jews. I did nothing because I wasn't a Jew. And now they're coming after them.
Yeah.
They're coming after these, these Obama friendly organizations and agencies, and now they're saying, well, hey, let's not do all this. How about, you know, you don't read our emails and charge us outrageous fees to get FOIA documents and so on and so forth.
We just don't realize the level of the extent of the monitoring and the spying that is being done on everybody. I know that.
Well, I think people, I may disagree with that to an extent, David, because I think people do realize it. They just don't care. You know, maybe they don't know to the full extent, but I watch a lot of these true crime shows. And, you know, when they're investigating this guy, all they do is like, yeah, we found out this because of his Facebook, and we found out this because of his text messages and his this and his that. And I'm sitting here watching this, you know, even though they had probable cause to do this to this guy. I mean, they found out all his personal information from his personal interactions, but I guess the average person, they can steal whatever they want from your Facebook or from your Twitter or go into your laptop. I believe you talked about it the other day about the guy. I believe his deadline was yesterday. He had to de-encrypt the files on his computer.
That's right.
Or, you know, go to jail.
That's right. What about the Fifth Amendment?
Yeah.
You know, we just had the IRS had invoked the Fifth Amendment, which was ironic because that's so many people use that as justification, saying they don't want to go through and fill out the paperwork from the IRS because it's essentially a very dangerous self-incrimination to fill out something that complicated and then be held to every detail of it. There's a famous, it didn't get much coverage at the time because we had pretty much a lock from the mainstream media, but there was a case with the IRS where there was a commercial airline pilot, and he had a very simple tax return. He was simply didn't have any investments, any businesses or anything. It was simply a wage issue. He filed his W-2. He paid all of his taxes, filled out his form, but refused to sign it. And the IRS took him to court and won over that.
Really?
And he said it's self-incrimination. And so now you've got the IRS official invoking the Fifth Amendment. And they're, when they compel this guy to go in and decrypt these files,
right,
that's in violation of the Fifth Amendment if he doesn't want to do that.
Exactly. And how, you know, they justified is, you know, I believe that particular case, the guy was alleged to have child pornography on his computer. And I then, you know, I was talking to one of the guys in the back, and I said, you know, that's how it first starts. Of course, I'm not advocating or, you know, supporting anybody who would do such activities, but that's how they can get by. Well, this guy had child porn, so we have to be able to decrypt his things or just throw him into jail without any actual real evidence. And that's how it starts. They start, you know, with some of the worst offenders, yeah, and it's going to get down to the point where, you know, we just want to know what's on your computer.
What's the way the RICO statutes started out? Racketeering and corruption. They went after the mafia first. They said, we can't get convictions against the mafia because they've got too much money and they can hire too good of lawyers. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is, when we accuse somebody of RICO, when we invoke that as a special incantation, that means that prior to conviction, we can go in and confiscate all their financial aspects. Well, fine. Okay. People said, oh, okay, yeah, they're going after the mafia and we know these guys are mafia, so we want them to get legal convictions,
right,
and take shortcuts. Well, it wasn't just a couple of years, they started going after pro-life demonstrators at abortion clinics, invoking the RICO statute.
Yeah.
So you got people like Randy Alcorn, who they won against him. They got everything from him, got a judgment against him. He's a best-selling Christian author, sells millions of copies of fictional books as well as other books that he writes. And he refused. They got a judgment. Planned Parenthood got a judgment. He lives on the minimum amount of money that the bankruptcy court would allow him to do, and gives away all the profits to these books because he's not going to give a cent to Planned Parenthood.
Yeah.
The point being that when you've got something like the RICO statute, or you've got these other things where you can always find somebody who's really horrible and say, because we got this horrible person, we want to get them, we are going to now suspend the rule of law, we're going to change all the rules. Well, they're going to change all the rules for everybody, not just for that heinous crime or that heinous criminal.
And this is kind of a nerdly example. You know, Alex makes all these Star Wars analogies. I'm a comic book guy. And what you're talking about, these RICO statutes and all these other things, if you watch, I believe it was the last two Batman movies, the one with the Joker, the one with Bane, the one with the Joker, they enacted the RICO statutes to throw all these mobsters into jail. And then in part three with Bane, you know, they have the guy questioning Commissioner Gordon, you know, who's Batman's right-hand man. He said, you stood by and let all this happen. You threw all these guys into jail without any, you know, real probable cause or evidence that they had even committed any crimes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and he said, yeah, your hands are just as dirty as, you know, Joker's or whoever else's.
That's right. We have to understand that these guarantees are there to protect innocent people. Criminals, you know, so many times people have said it's better to let a criminal go free than it is to punish innocent people.
Right.
I agree with that assessment. And I think that if we lose our protection of due process, we basically turn the government into criminals. And that's the really dangerous thing.
And we saw this recently with the Boston bombing thing. You know, I remember the bombing had happened, and then you just over the weekend, you know, I was, you know, at a restaurant or whatever watching some of the other news networks, and they're saying, yeah, they didn't read these guys,
Miranda rights.
Miranda rights.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we didn't have to give them that because of the circumstances, and, you know, we don't have to do that. If we feel this person's guilty, mm-hmm, you know, we're just going to railroad them without giving them their due process.
Just announce that. Announce that they're going to do it. And what you see, what we saw with the Boston Marathon bombing, you saw the press jump in with both feet.
Oh, yeah.
And no matter how ridiculous, how absurd, how many holes there were in the government's story, and no matter how frequently they changed it. I mean, it's just like what Issa said about Eric Holder. He said, you know, they're lying to us and they're constantly changing the story. I mean, they can't even pick a lie and stick to it. Same thing was happening there. No matter how ridiculous it was, the press fell in line, talked about that, and convicted him in the court of public opinion. You don't need that section of the NDAA that denies us our due process when you've got a compliant press and a government that works together to convict people in public opinion without ever having a trial or without ever having any discovery of any evidence. And that always happens.
And just thinking about that, when the younger brother, you know, he had injured his throat. I don't say, well, he injured it, but, you know, he gets out of the boat, you know, he looks fine. And then, you know, 10 minutes later, he's bleeding from the throat and he can't talk in the hospital, you know, and it was quietly kind of swept on the rug. It was reported, but quietly so that, oh, yeah, he was not injured when he came out of the boat. Like, well, how did he get injured? You know, it's just stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's very suspicious what happened to this guy down in Florida who was shot so many times, once in the back of the head. I mean, it's just it's just amazing when you see that. Well, talking about corruption, we're coming up to a break here, but do we have time for that? Yeah, we've got time for that report. Let's play this report. Give people a little bit of the background about Kissinger, because you know this stuff that's going on in South America under his leadership and connection. It was denied at the time. Subsequently, later documents came out that showed that he was very heavily involved. Mm-hmm. These documents were declassified, but the American people don't know very much about what happened in South America under Operation Condor. So let's talk a little bit about that, and let's talk a little bit about David Rockefeller. And we've got that report ready to run, guys. Okay, let's go to that right now. Frequent Bilderberg attendee Henry Kissinger has been in the news a lot lately. He was given the Intrepid Freedom Award by David Petraeus for his distinguished career defending the values of freedom and democracy.
I am deeply honored to present the 2013 Intrepid Award to my friend and my hero, the Honorable Henry A. Kissinger.
Petraeus should be more careful about who he kisses and who he kisses up to. Defending the values of freedom and democracy, Henry Kissinger? Apart from the secret bombing of Cambodia and allegations of other Vietnam War crimes, Kissinger was intimately involved with Operation Condor, a CIA campaign of terrorist operations and assassinations conducted in the 70s in South America.
They put me in the back of the truck. They then put scotch tape over our eyes, and I was very scared.
Like Operation Gladio in Europe, the CIA used terrorism to fight communism. But unlike Operation Gladio, Operation Condor defiantly operated in the open by the governments and killed more than 60,000 people.
And they had us standing there in a line. And I was the last one to be interrogated. And he, at that point, said, "You have to understand that we have to do these things because there are terrorists all over the country who would attack people like you Americans. And so we're doing this for your protection."
We had no contact with any of the people that carried out the military coup, and therefore the coup that overthrew Allende was done without contact with the United States.
Subsequent declassified documents showed he was lying. The dirty war, the night of the pencils, massacres, the disappeared, and death flights. These are the legacy of Kissinger, the CIA, and their South American partners.
There were two parallel universes. One was the life that, you know, you go to school, you go shopping, you catch the bus, and then you get to school, and some people didn't come back to school, and then people say, well, he was arrested or whatever. And so it was completely unreal, because you just went to school and they taught you math, history, music, and then you came back home to look for your dad, for your friends, and it's just completely unreal. You just start living this schizophrenic life where you pretend that everything is normal and then come back home, and then it's back to a tragedy.
The most dramatic moment of the hearing about Pinochet was the testimony of the Scotland Yard officer. On such and such a date, I was handed a warrant and I went to a house. At 11:30, I was shown in. I then went into a room and I saw a man that I recognized as the prisoner. Prisoner, isn't that a great room? The prisoner. And I walked up to him and he stood and I said, "Augusto Pinochet Ugarte, I arrest you, sir, for the crimes of conspiracy and torture." And I tell you, I thought, busted.
When Pinochet was arrested in London, Kissinger, who was also under investigation in several other nations, abruptly canceled his appearance there. But in addition to war crimes and terrorism, what Henry Kissinger is most remembered for is his opening to China, which was really about making China the slave labor manufacturing base for multinational corporations, all part of the politicians' and bankers' plans for world government.
We talk a lot about world community, but the fact is there has never been a world community before. We are now facing a common challenge. And the challenge is how to build a world order for the first time in history on a global basis.
China was the perfect place for the globalists to set up their base, a small ruling elite that ruled with an iron fist. Here's how Henry Kissinger did it.
When we started this relationship, there was next to no trade between China and the United States.
Kissinger then tells the audience that what he and Nixon first did was to allow American tourists in Hong Kong to buy up to $100 worth of Chinese goods. He says that was a daring move. The audience laughs, and then he says,
we have now reached a completely different stage in the relationship.
What an understatement. Arguably the quickest and most complete transfer of wealth in peacetime history. A transfer from the American people to a few Chinese ruling elite. Not from Americans to the Chinese people, but a transfer of wealth to multinational corporations and a few Chinese oligarchs who continue to use the Chinese people as slaves. The same oligarchs that Kissinger's patron, David Rockefeller, gushed in glowing praise back in 73. He said, whatever the price of the Chinese Revolution, it has obviously succeeded not only in producing more efficient and dedicated administration, but also in fostering high morale and community of purpose. The social experiment in China under Chairman Mao's leadership is one of the most important and successful in human history. Yeah, Mao and the Chinese communists really know how to treat the underclasses, according to Rockefeller.
I went to a Xinjiang area in Henan province and Anhui province to do interviews. The survivors there told me almost every village had cannibal incidents, and some people even ate their own children.
The Great Famine came amidst Mao's Great Leap Forward campaign.
When I was growing up, it's not uncommon for parents to tell their children, eat your food because children in China are starving. What we now know is that a conservative estimate of between 50 and 80 million were starved to death by Mao's policies. Mao's social experiment, the Cultural Revolution, the despotism that caused the starvation of tens of millions of people, Rockefeller calls the most important and successful experiment in human history. Kissinger and Rockefeller have exhibited contempt for both the rule of law and for human life throughout their lives. They and other globalists haven't just stolen American wealth. They've used the EU and the euro to create financial crisis in Europe, impoverishing Europeans and destroying national sovereignty throughout Europe. Just 3 days before the 2013 Bilderberg meeting, over 3,000 demonstrators protested the European Central Bank in Frankfurt. We now see the fruit of decades of secretive meetings being held by the Bilderberg Group with the leadership of Kissinger and Rockefeller. For 2 days, protesters have been protesting the fruits of Bilderberg past. Will they now cross the channel and protest Bilderberg in London as the banksters, puppet politicians, and Google plot their next steps? Bilderberg's role in creating European and international banking crises has to be exposed. And people need to ask why politicians and bankers are meeting in such closely guarded secrecy. The mainstream media's owners are there, but not the reporters. Infowars will be there, and we'll be reporting at Infowars.com/B for all the latest updates and information.
That was a great report, David.
Well, thank you. So what do you think? You think some of these people from Blockupy in Frankfurt might show up in Watford, England?
They may. They just may. And I was very impressed with that report because a lot of people, they say, what's the big deal about all these guys getting together? And I believe that's, you know, just one example of the type of people that are meeting there at the conference.
We'll be right back with more information about Bilderberg. Stay tuned.
Hi, my name is Annette, and due to menopause symptoms for nearly 2 years, I suffered severe hot flashes, which prevented me from sleeping all night. It was so hard to work because I continued all day to have the hot flashes from hell. I was exhausted and depleted. After only 3 weeks on One World Way, I have no hot flashes, and I'm sleeping normally again. I feel energized and strong. This is an amazing product.
It is a little-known fact that every single cell of your body is supposed to produce 10% of its protein content as glutathione. But due to toxicity and aging, it does not. Could glutathione be a missing factor in optimal cell function for your entire body? If you restore the optimal glutathione levels in your cells, especially your glands and organs, then as a result, your glands and organs work better. Imagine the quality of life improvement you might have. To order One World Way, call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. 888-988-3325 or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Shank, founder of eFoods Direct. Right now, we have a huge number of Americans that are in serious trouble right smack dab in the middle of the Oklahoma disasters. I know that thousands of you, like us, are frustrated with not being able to help those who have lost so much and are in so much pain. We can't stand idly by. Food is the best way to help the victims and support the relief effort. We have a plan for any of you who would like to partner with us in providing food in this desperate time of need. We've built a 7-day emergency food package containing breakfast, lunch, and dinner for a whole week for one adult, valued at $60. Your $25 will ship this life-saving supply directly to those in need. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. That's 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com. The food is contributed at considerably less than cost. Thank you.
Did you ever look at the stains in your coffee cup and then realize that's exactly what happens to your teeth? Power Swabs is the 5-minute solution to get your teeth white without visiting the dentist. This is John Greenhut, the CEO of Power Swabs. And if your teeth are stained from coffee, tea, or smoking, all it takes is 5 minutes with Power Swabs. In 5 minutes, you'll see an average of 2 shades whiter teeth, and in 7 days, 6 shades. It's clinically proven to whiten natural teeth as well as caps and veneers. The secret is a tooth detergent that was developed by Dr. Martin Ginniger that lifts stains off of your teeth. Best of all, there's no messy strips or trays that you have to leave in your mouth for an hour. Just swab your teeth for 5 minutes and you're done. To try Power Swabs risk-free, dial 1-800-960-9553. That's 1-800-960-9553. I guarantee your bright white smile will have your friends, family, and coworkers talking about how great you look. Try it risk-free today. 1-800-960-9553. That's 1-800-960-9553.
All right, I'm David Knight here with Jakari Jackson, and we're back. We've got a little bit of what is that music from The Outer Limits, I think. We are on the outer limits of reality, aren't we? We're covering the Bilderberg meeting in London, England, and Alex is there live with crew, with reporters. He's going to be back at the bottom of the hour in overdrive, but right now I've got Jakari Jackson in here with me, and we want to thank our sponsors and point out a couple of deals we got going. We've got... of course, Infowars.com/B for full coverage about Bilderberg. We also have a special going, helps to pay for expenses here, helps to keep this operation going. We've got a great special on ProPure water filters, and they're 15% off through the end of Bilderberg. So check that out at Infowarsshop.com.
And also we have this, Dave, the Infidel body armor, and I can tell you this feels pretty legit to me. I haven't torture tested it, but it definitely feels pretty strong. InfidelBodyArmor.com. It stops hundreds of rounds from AK-47s.
Yeah, they have torture tested
306s. I'd definitely like to see that myself. You can call 1-888-608-6605. That's 1-888-608-6605. And also one more thing, the InfoWars magazine. The current issue is about Bilderberg. You can see it right there. And also right there, you can see that weird skeleton thing that they have in their backyard out there. What happened to having garden gnomes and so on? They got this weird thing crawling around out there.
You know, Alex might be lucky that they actually threw him out of the restaurant. You know, I would wonder about eating at a place that has a statue like that out front, you know?
Yeah, that would definitely concern me. But, yeah, that's... I guess that's the kind of transhumanist things that they're into at Bilderberg.
Yeah, that's pretty creepy. And you know, it's interesting that the more they demand secrecy for themselves in the name of security and protecting us, whatever, the more they demand information about us. We just got this article here that was covered by Mail Online about students in Polk County, Florida, that are outraged because a school scanned their children, took iris scans of them, compulsory iris scans of them.
Oh, yeah.
It says they are essentially, of course, as we all know, they're optical fingerprints. And you've got this one comment from a parent on Facebook, and he says, this is stolen information and we cannot retrieve it.
Exactly, because they said that's going to be a different option to having the kids wear ID tags. I'm not sure if their ID tags have RFIDs or not, but they said, well, instead of doing the ID tags, we'll do this iris scan. And my understanding is they told the parents after they took the iris scans. So it wasn't something you could opt out of. We took your child's iris scan, and now we'll tell you about it. And they said they suspended the program after enough parents complained, but they still have the information.
Well,
and
you know, it's interesting.
Whoever the company is has the information.
The government schools have been used, and this is not any new news. This is something that Dewey and Horace Mann always talked about. It was an instrument of social design, social control. And we see in the last few years, they've been using them to, as a premier, to break down things like scanning the students and teaching them to live in a police state. And mm-hmm. so they've gone now from metal scanners and body scanners and teaching the kids to accept that as a normal, everyday way of life
right.
to putting biometric identification on the kids. I mean, you want to see where this is all headed? Look at what they're doing to your kids when you turn your kids over to the government.
And then, of course, then your child comes home and you say, as a parent, you know, I don't like these RFIDs, or I don't like these iris scans, and your kid looks at you like, what's the big deal? We do that at school, you know, however many school days there are a year. You know, that's what they do. That's what they're used to. It's prisoner training.
Yeah, oh, yeah, absolutely. It's prisoner training. We're going to be right back. We're going to go into overdrive, and we're going to have Alex Jones doing a live report from London in overdrive. So stick around.
For listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Cal-Bend Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soap that is triple concentrated and made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a free catalog and buy American-made products. Order the sampler, a 1 to 2 month supply, or get a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. You're getting soap products twice as good as what you're using now. This is an amazing deal, and you will love the way real soap makes your skin feel. Call 1-800-340-7091 or visit www.5starsoap.com. Alex and his staff have used these earth-friendly, pure soaps for years. See them on the web, www.5starsoap.com, or call 1-800-340-7091 for a catalog.
Coast to coast. Direct from Austin, you're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Infowars Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and I'm here with Jakari Jackson. And we just began overdrive, and we're going to have Alex at the bottom of the hour doing some live reports from London, so stick around.
And also check out Infowars.com/B. The B as in Bilderberg. You can type out the whole word if you want. Also, you can go to Infowars.com/show, but we do recommend Infowars.com/B.
And one of the things we haven't been mentioning is we do have a Twitter hashtag, #Bilderberg. So if you want to comment on that Bilderberg page, there's actually a live feed of what people are tweeting about Bilderberg. So if you want to comment, if you want to redirect people to articles there, it'll show up in that on that page. So you can follow the conversation there if you look at #Bilderberg. Well, Jakari, Kathleen Sebelius has been in the news quite a bit lately.
Yeah,
she's
I know her.
just in the last couple of days, she's had several things break on her. She's been at the center of, we talked about this earlier, these fake email accounts that they're setting up, and that involved her department. And then she's also, it's broken that she was asking companies to support the healthcare law. putting pressure on them for that. And now we've got this situation here with her and this controversy about this little girl trying to get a transplant and her not waiving the rules for that.
Yeah, and my understanding about that was the family of the child wrote a very personal letter. I believe they actually wrote, "I beg you," or "We're begging you to help us, you know, get past these rules and regulations." And I believe Ms. Sebelius, her comment was that, you know, we have other children in that same hospital that are, you know, just as critical condition. It's a tricky thing, you know?
Yeah.
It's definitely a tricky thing.
I guess one of the things that made it news that really kind of got people's attention was kind of the cavalier way that Kathleen Sebelius replied to this. This is a little girl, and she's got 5 weeks to live, and she says, someone lives, someone dies.
Yes, that was, you know, the very controversial thing. Was it that guy said, death is a part of life? Was that in the Benghazi hearings, or somebody said something along those lines? And the very cavalier, nonchalant aspect of these people.
But it brings up, again, this death panel aspect and the idea that we don't have decisions about even healthcare treatment, that that's being taken away from us. And, of course, Kathleen Sebelius, exactly. That cuts to the core of so many of the, of course, there's so many different aspects of Obamacare. I mean, one of it is the coercive aspect of it. Another one is just the practical aspect of it. We see that the British healthcare system is imploding under government control. And we've seen that happen over and over again. And so people are concerned just about that aspect of it. But they're also concerned about the fact that they don't get to have any say-so whatsoever. Once the government comes in with hard, fast rules and regulations, they're not going to let you go around that system whatsoever. And you've got the situation in England where you can't even, you have to have their permission to go see a private doctor.
Yeah, and I believe that happened to Paul Joseph Watson. Mm-hmm. You know, he got sick and, you know, he went to, you know, the doctor and they gave him some little Alka-Seltzer pills or something like that. It didn't do the trick because they have that system of healthcare.
And you got to wait a long time before you can even see. So they have to basically triage that. You have to get permission to go to a private doctor. That's just amazing.
But when
and to do that, you've got to wait in line.
These I love Obamacare sticker. I see those things everywhere here in the city of Austin. And I mean, these are probably a lot of good, well-meaning people, but they just didn't, you know, they didn't read the fine print. They didn't really look into what this stuff is about.
Well, it's just the coercive nature of it and the rigid nature of it. And this case right here, regardless of this transplant issue, I mean, just this authoritarian, we're going to decide everything about your health care.
Right.
That's what really scares a lot of people. Well, we're going to be right back. I'm here with Jakari Jackson, and we've got Alex is going to be joining us at the bottom of the hour with some live reports. So stay tuned.
Introducing Pro One, all of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gates, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Your home alarm works after an intruder is inside your home, but real home security begins before intruders enter. Burglaries and home invasions are at an all-time high, and crime is skyrocketing in rural and suburban areas. 85% of break-ins are through a door, and police response is often greater than 20 minutes. You can't afford to wait that long. Stop burglars with police-tested and recommended Easy Armor from Armor Concepts. Easy Armor keeps intruders out, it's barely visible, and installs easily. Easy Armor reinforces a door's armor's weak points, comes in three colors, and is guaranteed to stop kick-ins. Get easy armor now and get peace of mind. Order by calling 888-58-ARMOR. That's 888-582-7667. Or go to easyarmor.net, spelled EZARMOR.net. Special offer only available to GCN listeners. Ask about it when you call for your easy armor today from Armored Concepts. Ultimate door security made easy.
Did you ever look at the stains in your coffee cup and then realize that's exactly what happens to your teeth? PowerSwabs is the five-minute solution to get your teeth white without visiting the dentist. This is John Greenhut, the CEO of PowerSwabs. And if your teeth are stained from coffee, tea, or smoking, all it takes is 5 minutes with PowerSwabs. In 5 minutes, you'll see an average of 2 shades whiter teeth, and in 7 days, 6 shades. It's clinically proven to whiten natural teeth as well as caps and veneers. The secret is a tooth detergent that was developed by Dr. Martin Ginniger that lifts stains off of your teeth. Best of all, there's no messy strips or trays that you have to leave in your mouth for an hour. Just swab your teeth for 5 minutes and you're done. To try PowerSwabs risk-free, dial 1-800-960-9553. That's 1-800-960-9553. I guarantee your bright white smile will have your friends, family, and coworkers talking about how great you look. Try it risk-free today. 1-800-960-9553. That's 1-800-960-9553.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, welcome back. I'm David Knight here with Jakari Jackson, and Alex Jones is, in fact, getting some answers. He's getting some answers in London, and he's going to have a report for us at the bottom of the hour. And until then, we can take some calls. We've got a 800 number here for you to call. It's 800-259-9231. Call in and tell us what's on your mind. Let's talk a little bit maybe about Bilderberg. And we'll take any calls. We'll even take calls from outside the country, but I'm not sure what that number is.
We have plenty of people from outside the country. But while we're waiting for those callers to get online, I have this article, David. The Wi-Fi in your home can track moves like Xbox Kinect. Now, of course, you know, some people are familiar with Xbox Kinect system. Basically, it uses your movements to play video games and so forth. Now they're saying technology is so advanced that they can basically track what you do in your home. For example, if you have your Wi-Fi devices connected, and if there's a video that goes along with this, we're not going to show for the sake of time. But in the video, the developer says if you have a Wi-Fi device such as a laptop or even an iPhone, that would be a strong enough signal to allow you to do things like wave your hand and turn on your TV, or, you know, turn on your blender by flicking your wrist. And, you know, I'm not a technophobe. You know, I definitely see this could benefit people with disabilities and so forth. But just think about this, how they want to control every aspect of your life. Well, let's say, for example, if you live in an apartment complex like I do, you know, I have a one occupancy apartment, but there are plenty of people who have a one bedroom apartment who have 10 people living in their apartment.
That's right. That's
you know, so, and let's say those people aren't supposed to be there, at least not living there on a permanent basis. So if they can sense your movements, they can sense that it's not one person in this house. It's not one person that maybe a dog or a cat. You've got 10 people living in this apartment. So when you start moving around, what if your electricity just cuts off?
Well, you know, my background is in engineering, and I always looked at technology as a good thing, as an empowering thing. But over and over and over again, the theme that we keep seeing coming back is that they're using technology for control. Mm-hmm. They're using it for surveillance. And we just had an interview earlier this week with Sheila Hemphill, who was successful in at least getting in the option to opt out of smart meters because they're very concerned about the intensity of the wireless signals that are being shot out. It's 300 times that of a cell phone. And there's a lot of concern, a lot of real health concerns about this technology, about a lot of this wireless technology and the strength of the strength of the signals that are coming out and the health impacts on that. We had expert testimony. We had a person on the interview at the end of the interview who had given expert testimony in Canada, and he was talking about this guy was not even in the medical field. He was a consultant who was looking at the effect of pulsing high energy waves like we're getting with Wi-Fi and like we're getting with these smart meters. He was looking at the way it affected the building integrity, the way it was fatiguing structural materials.
Right.
And so you got to wonder when you're seeing real measurable changes in the structural materials, what it's doing to people, because we have electrical signals that are running all through our body, as well as what it's doing to soft tissue.
It's frequency pollution. That's what she explained in that interview. And it's not just in things such as Wi-Fi. She did the demonstration a little bit afterwards where she showed us a light bulb. You know, she had her, I'm not exactly sure what you call it, her sensor, and she held it up to a light bulb, one of those curly Q light bulbs, and the thing just went crazy. Mm-hmm. And it's far beyond just things such as Wi-Fi, and it very much concerns me when we look at things like these new Wi-Fi systems, you know, a signal so powerful you can turn on TVs in different rooms and so forth. That's a lot of frequency pollution that you're absorbing into your body.
Absolutely. And as we talked about in the interview, it's not just the privacy issue that we're concerned about. It's not just the health issue that we're concerned about. You know, there's a lot of people out there who, like we were talking about earlier, they don't care about their privacy. Mm-hmm. They don't care about your privacy.
No.
And they may not believe the health issues. What they need to believe, though, is that this is going to be used to raise their electricity rates. They're looking at this to, again, monitor what people are doing and adjust it accordingly, because we're seeing a massive decline in the affordability of electricity and in the production of electricity. To manage that decline and to keep the power company's profits up, they're going to charge you a differential price based on the time of day that you use your service.
Yeah, I believe you talked about that yesterday, you know, peak hours. Mm-hmm. So let's say, you know, you have, you know, maybe your grandma or somebody comes to visit you on the weekend. Well, you don't normally use that amount of electricity. So, you know, once you hit, X number, we just cut it off.
Right. Well, or the other part of it is charging people a lot when they're using it during the peak hours. Mm-hmm. People don't have control over that. In an experiment that they did in Chicago, they found that it did not affect people's use of energy. Why? Because you don't have control over that. If people had control over the time that they go to work, you wouldn't have rush hour traffic in every city, right? People would opt out. They would opt to go at a different time. But they have to go at a particular time. They have to use that electricity at that time. They're going to charge them a lot more money to use electricity at that period of time. It's all about managing a decline in our lifestyle and cheap available energy, which has really kind of funded not only driven our economy, but also helped us to achieve a better standard of living and a longer lifespan. They're taking that away.
And it makes surveillance fun and trendy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you got video games, you can turn on your TVs and all that stuff.
Absolutely. Well, we got some callers that have lined up here. We've got, let's go to one of them. The first one here is Julio in Illinois. Julio, are you there?
Afternoon, gentlemen. You know, I was at Bilderberg last year in Chantilly, Virginia, and I remember actually eating breakfast inside the Westfield Marriott Hotel the day before the conference and having a police escort me out, or drinking at the Wellington Pub with Mark Dice and other activists last year, and being able to actually meet Jim Tucker in person and actually have a conversation with Mr. Tucker last year was truly an experience unlike any other. And as an independent journalist, hearing for years, oh, this group doesn't exist, and actually being on the ground last year, seeing Austin Goolsbee, who was President Obama's economic advisor, who you can see him on Sean Hannity's program on Fox News all the time, or seeing literally Henry Kissinger in his deathmobile driving through the grounds of the Marriott last year. It was truly an astonishing experience to be a part of, and just seeing corporate media here in the States not even touching the subject. Last year they had the Daily Caller, which is Tucker Carlson's pseudo-libertarian news outlet. They tried to do what the BBC tried to do to Alex Jones a few hours ago down in Watford, tried to
get a soundbite.
Provoke the peaceful protesters and trying to get them to sound stupid. And a couple of days ago, it was actually on Monday, I tweeted Jake Tapper, who's the host of The Lead on CNN. He used to be on ABC News. I tweeted Jake Tapper on my Twitter at JN Reports. I asked Jake, are you going to be covering Bilderberg this week? Are you going to be covering this secret meeting in Watford? And he told me that we may or may not cover Bilderberg, but if we do, it's not going to be because of my obnoxious tweets. And I guess obnoxious tweets now is asking
a question.
Corporate media journalists whether or not they're going to cover a secret meeting. You know, you just type in Bilderberg onto any search engine's news tab, and you're seeing mainstream articles from the London Guardian, the Daily Mail, and so forth, but where's corporate media? You're not going to get any coverage. But, you know, I look at some of the people who are attending Bilderberg, and I heard Alex talk about maybe an hour and a half ago about Peter Thiel, who is one of the founders of Facebook, supposedly this libertarian man. I've been doing my fair share of research on Peter Thiel since last year. He's a part of the Bilderberg Steering Committee. And you don't become a member of the Steering Committee if you're not an evil person, if you haven't sold your soul. And one of his front groups is called Breakout Labs. Breakout Labs, Breakout Labs, breakoutlabs.org, I believe is the website. Mm-hmm. And Peter Thiel is donating millions of dollars into the biotech world. Millions of dollars into trying to harness the energy of tornadoes. He's spending millions of dollars on really this technocracy. And, I think my cat Sudstein a lot. If I'm not mistaken,
I think Peter Thiel was at the transhumanist conference that Ray Kurzweil and all those guys had back in the fall. So, I mean, I think he's into this transhumanist movement as well, you know, the statue that we see out in front of Bilderberg.
No, absolutely. And if people just take the time to research Breakout Labs and see where Peter Thiel's billions of dollars are going to, it's going towards this technocracy. And there's one woman, I forgot her name, it's like Susan, it's on the official attendees list, but there's one woman who is the chief economist of Microsoft, and she also was buddy buddies with the Rand Corporation.
Well, I think what you're going to see with Bilderberg is you've got these younger people, Jeff Bezos, perhaps, the Google influence that's coming in. They understand that they can't contain this as a secret anymore. They understand that it's making them look like a bunch of fools and liars because they've been liars about this. Yeah. Because it's such an obviously the secret is out in the open.
You can
and the
use
more
their
they ignore
own
it,
tools to research
right.
Bilderberg.
The more they ignore it, the more ridiculous they look. The more they lose credibility. So what they're going to do is they're going to try to spin this in a positive way. And we've already seen a lot more reports talking about this, how, Bilderberg came together and it was originally set up to try to make sure that we were going to have world peace. Well, we've had 60 years of continuous war.
Exactly.
Since they got set up.
Not doing a very good job.
You said that you're an alternative media person. What's your contact information?
People can follow me on Twitter at JN Reports. Actually submitted genetically modified society into the Operation Paul Revere contest.
Okay, great.
And one last thing, I just looking at Bilderberg and looking at just how even just last year seeing almost 1,000 people outside the Westfields Marriott, and Lord willing, there's going to be a large number of people just outside of London this weekend. It's showing, and even Sidney Brzezinski admitted this a few weeks before I went to Bilderberg last year. He admitted that people are waking up.
Sorry,
to the new world order.
I've got to. Thanks for calling. I got to cut you off, but we're going to be back with some more calls right after this break. So stay tuned.
Hello, I'm Alex Jones. Myself, my family, the Infowars.com team want to relay to you and your families that we are intensifying our efforts against the globalist on every front. Infowars.com is leading the fight against the technocrats. But we can't do that without your help. By getting the films, bumper stickers, and t-shirts at Infowars.com, you will wake up people in your area and support our operation as we move to the next level. We need your help to spread the word like never before. They wish to hide themselves during this tectonic battle between the forces of freedom and darkness. You are the response to the globalist technocrats and their program of global eugenics dehumanization and ultimate extermination. The war is here. It's an info war. The spirit of 1776 versus the mindset of 1984.
big business has discovered the preparedness market, and that makes it difficult to know where to go and who to trust. MyPatriotSupply.com is owned and operated by patriots just like you, has the best prices on storable food, non-GMO seeds, water filtration devices, home canning equipment, survival and self-reliance books, and more. MyPatriotSupply.com has old-fashioned values and the absolute best customer service in the industry. Look for the deal of the day, unique affordable survival supplies that fit anyone's budget. Get same-day shipping on all orders and free shipping on orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927, 866-229-0927, or visit MyPatriotSupply.com for emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence. Shop with a name you know and a name you can trust. Before it's time to survive, it's time to prepare. MyPatriotSupply.com.
Hi, this is Gary Cooper with Midas Resources Gold and Silver. Don't be surprised when the global elite confiscates money from your bank account one day. They have already very clearly telling you that they're going to do it. With what just happened in Cyprus serving as a blueprint for future bank bailouts, if you are concerned about keeping your money, why not consider storing your wealth in gold and silver? Call me, Gary Cooper, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 130. Together, we'll discuss your options of buying gold and silver. Again, the global elite have plans for your money, and it doesn't include you. So call me, Gary Cooper, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 130. And I will send you a booklet with 10 reasons why gold and silver could be right for you. Again, don't get caught with money in your account when the next bank bailout hits. Call me, Gary Cooper, at 1-800-686-2237, extension 130.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
In 1814, we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson. Okay, the War of 1812. We took a little bacon and they burned the White House down.
Yeah.
We've got Alex in London right now, and he's not trying to burn anything down, but he's going to be bringing us some information as soon as we get him connected. He's going to be joining us about the bottom of the hour, but it depends on connections that we've got there. But I've got Jakari Jackson with me here, and we're covering the news, and we're taking your calls. We've got Daniel on the line from Canada. Daniel, are you there?
Hi, good afternoon, sir. Nice talking to you both again.
Hey, good talking to you.
I just had two quick things to bring up, if you don't mind commenting on. The first thing is the surveillance grid, and you both are absolutely right. On WikiLeaks, I was just looking around, too, if you look at the left side of the column, about the spy files, it shows literally in almost every different country, every agency that's monitoring every form of communication, like text messaging, phone calls, internet access, all that stuff. So quick comment on that, if you don't mind.
Yeah, it's really, I mean, well, what do you think, Jakari? I mean, they're looking at everything we're doing, and of course, we've got the Utah data center coming online.
Yeah, not just there. I mean, these things are all over. Like I said, we've been to the one in San Antonio, and bring it up, WikiLeaks, I don't want people to forget about the trial of Bradley Manning.
That's right.
I believe he's in his second day of trials, maybe the third. I was reading an article a little bit earlier how they had full press coverage, or at least the press area of the courtroom was full the first day and the second day and the third day. Now there's hardly anybody covering that event. So I definitely want people to not forget about him and his situation of, exposing some of those sensitive information. But yeah, I definitely would encourage anybody who was interested in that information. If you have friends and family who don't believe that there's anybody spying on you 24 hours a day, I definitely would direct them there to see what was going on.
Well, you know, they're playing real hardball with any of the whistleblowers. We had last week Karen Hudes, who worked for about 20 years for the World Bank.
Right.
And as a lawyer there, she saw some corruption and she saw loans being made that didn't qualify. And when she spoke out about it, they came after her pretty hard. And the amazing thing is that even, you know, there were elements within the World Bank that wanted to expose the fraud and the misconduct that were there. But there's a heavy American presence. And it was really the American side that was trying to shut her up.
Mm-hmm.
And even after she got an invitation to come back and speak at the World Bank meeting, they had the U.S. Secret Service. Now, understand that the World Bank is a separate entity that the U.S. has maybe a 15% share in. And so you got the U.S. Secret Service saying she couldn't go, even though the World Bank people wanted to hear. Yeah, they wanted to hear her whistleblowing exposure of the corruption that she saw. And it wasn't just her. It was several other people within the World Bank. The Secret Service said she couldn't. She is a lawyer, so she basically presented evidence to them and gave them the record saying that she was invited. When she showed up, they arrested her. And now they're charging her, the Eric Holder's Justice Department is charging her for unlawful entry.
Eric
it's really
Holder
amazing.
To investigate his own organization.
That's right. I mean, it's amazing that they go out of their way into an area where they don't really have any jurisdiction and they start attacking people who are whistleblowers. It's very concerning that we see this kind of overreaching bullying of people who are basically exposing fraud and corruption. It's a time where they demand absolutely not only transparency, but they demand micro surveillance of every single thing that we do. Mm-hmm. And yet they come down so hard when anybody looks at anything that they're doing. I mean, just you know, that's the essence of Bilderberg is secrecy.
So. Exactly.
We have another caller on the line, Mike from Tennessee. Mike, are you there?
Can you hear me?
Yes, Mike.
Okay. Yeah, I wanted to talk about the situation where you've got a Chinese company buying up the largest pork producer in the world here in the United States, and clearly they indicate that the products will be exported to China. So you look at the condition right now where across the country they're trying to shut down the small family farmers from being able to raise pigs and outlawing their ability to do so, and they're taking these multinational corporations and funneling all of the proceeds of this country into other countries, and they're buying up these companies with devalued U.S. dollars, which China's a flood of. And you look at the connection with this company who was at one time controlled by Goldman Sachs, and there's a few articles on the internet where if you just search this company's name and money laundering, you'll find that some of these articles were up and now they've been removed. So this thing looks like one big sham where the Chinese government is basically buying up assets of this country and basically strategically starving this country ultimately.
Absolutely. Well, if you go back and you look at that, that's really the history of Bilderberg. It's what we covered in that special report earlier. There's been a massive transfer of wealth and technology to China because they know that they can control those people there. We'll be right back. I'm gonna leave you.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Introducing Pro One, all of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Great news, pure water lovers. BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com has a special discount offer for all GCN listeners. You can't do better than a Big Berkey for economy. For only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. There's none better than a Big Berkey for emergency preparedness as a backup water source. And you just can't beat a Big Berkey to remove dangerous chlorine, all types of fluoride, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, parasites, and unhealthy byproducts from municipal water. Berkey water filter systems are even powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. For the gold standard in water filters, get a Big Berkey at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And all GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. For details, call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey water filters, for the love of clean water.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618, BlockitPocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live right now.
Hey, how you doing? Unbelievable.
God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, in the last 30 seconds, I've run into three listeners walking down by the Houses of Parliament. I mean, my God, Infowars is on fire in Britannia. And there is Big Ben, now called Big Queen Elizabeth II, literally named after Queen Elizabeth. And we are here, and this is unprecedented. Watson, where are you at? Watson. I just ran into three people that are listeners in like 20 seconds.
I've been following you on here, trying to track you down.
Oh, my God. You're a listener, too?
Of course so, yeah.
My God. I mean, this is insane. We just ran into three guys right there.
Yeah.
That shows people are awake, huh?
Yeah.
Man, that's awesome. All these, I mean, it's not about our show being big. It's about the fact that people are really waking up. What's your name? What do you want to say to folks out there?
Mark. I don't know what to say. Because I watch you every day. And when you said you were coming in at Big Ben, I thought, I live in London.
Oh, that's why we're running into the listeners. You guys came down here.
I said
it about an hour. Wow, is that why you came down?
Yeah, I'm from London.
Oh, that's why I just ran into a bunch of listeners. Wow, that was crazy. Well, God bless you.
We're
going to go broadcast out on the bridge live. Very exciting. Well, it's not called Big Ben anymore, though. It's supposed to call it Queen Elizabeth, our supreme leader.
Yeah. I'm Scottish, she ain't no leader of mine.
I'm being sarcastic. Hey, she's a McAdoo, look right there.
That's right, good Scottish name as well. Good to see.
All right, buddy, good to see you.
Good to meet you, man.
Good to meet you, sir. Awesome. God bless you. All right, let's go, guys. Let's go to the next level. Wow. What are those birds circling, Paul?
Vultures.
Vultures. Ladies and gentlemen, we are broadcasting live. Now, I thought we'd really gotten crazy because like, I got out of the car. And every person we ran into was a listener. But now I figured it out. They heard me say an hour ago we were coming down here. And this is just insane. Hey, how you doing? Oh, my gosh. Everybody's awake down here. What is going on in England, Watson? People are really awake, man. People have been listening. There is Big Ben, now known as Queen Elizabeth. Not joking, they've renamed it. It's like Queen Elizabeth Tower, right, Watson?
No, it's still Big Ben.
It's still Big Ben, even if they say so? Even if they say it doesn't exist? How's my audio, guys? Because there's some high winds out here. Sound fine? Ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing a historic moment as Bilderberg is blown wide open. Wow, what's that new building? Is that the Shard?
Yeah.
It's like an alien spacecraft that's left, landed. Again, we're down here exposing Bilderberg 2013. And we're right down here at Big Ben. Great job of the whole crew. We drove in here from northwest of London in about 45 minutes. And we are here. There is Big Ben for people watching at Infowars.com/Bilderberg. Jakari Jackson, David Knight, what do you make of these images that we're showing you here? We may have found life in England.
Well, it's very encouraging to see all those listeners.
New World Order.
It says very encouraging to see all those listeners you were able to find out there in just a short period of time.
Absolutely. It's unbelievable. We've got listeners all over the place here. And I had no idea that I'd say like an hour ago that I was coming down here. And this is a huge complex. We, you know, they could never know where we'd randomly park. There's the big London Eye right there that I run into like six or seven listeners. And then other people walking by are waving and saying, we hate Piers Morgan. I guess that Air Army scandal over here when that happened. I'm about to take you out on the Thames River here. The audio from the network is really low, guys. I can barely hear Jakari. If you can boost it, thank you. The crew's amazing. Again, we're all just testing out new technologies out here. David Knight, what do you make of this?
Hey, I saw it looked like you had the statue of Cromwell there on the side. I wonder, they must have put him on the opposite side of the Queen Elizabeth Tower.
They did, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of a oil and water thing there, I guess. Cromwell doesn't go too good with royalty.
No, he killed him, didn't he? Or?
Yeah. He took over for a while. He actually cut the head off of King Charles II, I think. I don't know. I had to brush up on my history a little bit.
Yeah, a bunch of my ancestors were involved with Cromwell, and then they were the Pilgrims after that and moved to the U.S.
Yeah.
Well, it looks great. Because I'm a Vatican assassin, I'm involved with Cromwell. Anyways, I just keep reporting on how awake people are. I think that's the there's the Thames, folks. I think that's really the main issue here. Is that people are so awake. What do you say, Jakari Jackson?
Well, that's what I was going to ask you, David. Alex. Do you think it's because Bilderberg is in town, or, you know, maybe that's a question for Watson. Are people normally informed and awake?
You know, Jakari, I think it's a complex of a bunch of different issues, but people know they're being screwed. They know they're being lied to. They know that mainstream media is deceiving them, so they're looking for answers. And not many people are willing to get outside the box in the media, but there's massive numbers of people who aren't in media who are awake. And so that's what's happening right now is humanity, it's on so many levels, is just ready for freedom. They're ready for reality, they're ready for the truth, and they're tired of being told there's no back rooms, there's no special interest. You know, we're gonna take hundreds of billions of dollars every few months from the U.S. and give it to private interests, but the tales of that are secret. We're going to give tens of billions of pounds every month of U.K. money and give it to private interest. And then you find out it's not even public debt. It's money for them. People get it that not only are these people robbing us, they're robbing us to make us poor to politically control us. So,
and you're right there. You're right there in front of the Parliament building, because it's not just Big Ben that's there, but that's the Westminster building right there. That's where Parliament meets. And that's where they're having this big lobbyist scandal that's happening right now, where they're talking about transparency and accountability. And at the same time, just up the road at Bilderberg, they've got just the opposite of transparency and accountability on a massive level.
Well, that's right. And this is about reawakening the fact that there are special interests that want to try to control our lives. And so that's what this is about. But we've got British members of Parliament, German members of their Bundestag coming out who've been Bilderberg attendees, and they're saying it's wrong and it's evil. So they've gone from it doesn't exist to now it exists, but don't worry about it. I know I've said that 100 times. This is a big deal right now that people all over the world are discovering that they can't just be trusting lemmings. And once we're not trusting lemmings anymore, now we begin to study how the world really works. We start playing the real game of life. They want us playing, you know, fake video games, watching movies, being obsessed with Hollywood crap, while the real world is actually going on all around us. And Paul Watson here today, what is your take on the different things that are unfolding here as we're here by the Parliament, while we have this huge scandal going on because of lobbying with members of Parliament having to step down, but then the real lobbying is going on at Bilderberg?
Well, I mean, You've got 140 of the world's most influential people meeting at Bilderberg. You've got them all involved in lobbying. You've got people involved in the LIBOR scandal, the HSBC shipping, laundering drug money. You've got people involved in the subprime mortgage collapse, all visiting Bilderberg. And then you've got the mainstream media here in the UK focusing on a lobbying scandal, which is 10 times lesser in importance. And then the state media, the BBC, turns up at Bilderberg, says it's all conspiracy theory. They've got no power, doesn't really exist. And it's amazing. It's embarrassing, actually. I find it embarrassing.
Well, Paul, I'll ask you, because Alex had brought up the point that all the people he had met so far are so awake. Since you're more familiar with the area, are people more, you know, awake in general, or is it because you think Bilderberg's in town?
No, actually, we've been traveling to several different places, and a lot of the people aren't even aware of Bilderberg, but they're generally awake. They know who Alex Jones is. And Alex was actually saying, in comparison to a lot of places in America, they're very docile. And when he came over here to Europe, the general state of, you know, people being awakened was very noticeable. Mm-hmm. We've talked to a lot of enlightened people already. People are coming up to Alex on the street every 10 seconds.
Paul wants to say hi to some of our listeners.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Just talking about the fact that a lot of people are more awakened here in Europe compared to Texas.
Well, I mean, I got a lot of listeners awake, but the people are more tuned in.
Yeah. So that's what we've experienced so far in the first few days.
Love it. I like the
whole right. So we're just watching the footage. If you're a new watcher, new listener, you can go to infowars.com/B. Also infowars.com/listen. Hashtag Bilderberg, and you can follow all the InfoWars updates. We're watching some of the viewers and listeners who are meeting Alex and the crew right now. They're outside Big Ben.
And Parliament.
Yes.
You know, Paul, you mentioned HSBC, the money laundering, the drug issues going on there. Maybe that explains why David Petraeus is there. You know, maybe they needed some help doing the money laundering and the drug trade a little bit better. He's had so much experience there with the CIA and Afghanistan. Maybe he can offer HSBC a little bit of pointers.
Are you a listener?
Yeah. That's quite possible, yes. I guess he's got a lot more time on his hands now.
That's right. That's right.
But there's a lot of interesting people out. We've heard Bill Gates is in London for a function.
Hey, tell folks all the listeners that are showing up.
We're just
we can see the listeners.
We only got around the corner, just looking around Big Ben. We're being mobbed.
It's getting harder and harder for Alex to cover anything because everybody recognizes him.
It's amazing, and we're expecting at least a couple of thousand people at Bilderberg. It's going to be a massive crowd. They're already starting to crack down with the security, the police pushing us back.
Right.
It's already turning into a circus, but, you know, it's exciting.
So, Paul, tell us how people can catch up with Bilderberg. Actually, if they're physically there in the location, where do they need to go? What do they need to know?
Well, it's in Watford. You go to Watford Junction train station, and then the Grove Hotel is literally about 10-minute taxi ride from there. Watford is obviously northwest of London. It's 20 minutes direct from London on a train. So anyone in the area, is, you know, they've really got no excuse. They've got to be there. Mm-hmm. And we're expecting a massive turnout, and I'd encourage everybody
to get marijuana out here.
Yeah.
Okay, so watching, we saw the videos of them checking people's papers going in and out of neighborhoods. Can somebody expect to have their papers checked if they try to go to the hotel?
Yeah, I've grabbed the audio here. So yes, it's martial law in Watford is basically what's going on. And again, we are here. Can you guys see the images for PrisonPlanet.tv viewers?
Yes. Yes.
Can you see the image of Big Ben? How cool is this to be broadcasting live from here?
That looks great. Looks great.
Oh, well, Big Ben's going off. Listen, hold on. Listen. Babylon. Can you hear it, guys?
Yeah, we can hear it.
Yep. Coming through good.
You can hear it. You can hear it bonging?
Oh, yeah, we can hear it. Wow. So what time of day is it out there, or night?
It's like, what is it, 8 o'clock at night? What time is it? 8:45.
Okay, so what time can people expect, Alex, what time can people expect the festivities or whatever you want to call it to kick out over at Bilderberg?
I mean, there's already a lot of protesters showing up, but tomorrow afternoon's when it all starts as we identify the real globalist threat.
tomorrow,
I guess Bong's at 15 minutes till.
Tomorrow is when you're really going to see a lot of pickup and activity there at Bilderberg. Is that correct? Because you were there Monday. They hadn't even cordoned off the rooms on Monday. And then yesterday, people really hadn't started to arrive. So I guess today they're starting to arrive.
The police just showed up there today. We just got there early as an advance team. But you guys want to go to the other side of the bridge? Well, I appreciate you guys working so hard. We've got an amazing amount of videos that have already been uploaded. Hi, how you doing? Did you come down here or are you already down here?
No, I came to see you.
Well, you're awesome. Welcome. So just like an hour and a half ago, you guys are on tape? You want to be on video?
Sorry?
If you don't want to be on video, that's okay. I won't show you.
No, but...
Oh, look at this. The bunch of listeners. So you heard me an hour and a half ago say we were coming down by Big Ben and you're here.
All my mates are watching your show. They said come back.
Well, that's fantastic. Yeah. How many people in the UK are listening to the show?
Because there's a lot. Yeah.
I've been on trains with like a third of the people that listen. That's crazy.
Yeah, there's a lot, yeah.
You think about the last 10 years you were here, how many were
there? No, this is like 10 times the last time I was here.
So it just showed you the fact.
Yeah, people are waking up.
Yeah, well, people
can see
it's cramping.
Can we say death to the New World Order?
Death to the New World Order.
All right, awesome. Well, it's a real pleasure meeting all you guys.
Peace and love.
Peace and another listener right there. I guess we're in the fading light here, but it's definitely nice. I tell you, Paul, this is crazy.
It's a circus.
You want to cross the street, or what do you want to do?
Yeah, we could go down there.
Jakari, David Knight, what do you guys got lined up for the nightly news? Let's cross here so we can... Is there a crossroad
over
there?
Well, for the nightly news, tonight at 7 p.m. Central, we'll have a contestant from the Operation Paul Revere contest. We'll be covering a lot of news, such as this, the Wi-Fi in your house, tracking you, as well as any new Bilderberg updates that you guys have out of London. So it's going to be a good show tonight. I believe Rob Dew is going to do the interview. I'll do the news portion tonight at 7 p.m. Central.
Also, I just want to point out that we've uploaded like 10 videos today. Because we're having the same phone to the live broadcast, we haven't uploaded the BBC lady yet. But
that's the one we really wanted to show. You guys going to have that one ready?
Absolutely. You'll have to dig through the videos we upload. Part of it's already up there, but where she was trying to... Oh, here we go. Hey, Watson, what's the word she used? She was trying to make me mad.
Provoke
me. She's like, it does not exist.
Well, Alex, we may have some new listeners, so could you tell that story again?
Well, it's just the BBC wanted to interview me, so I drove down there, and they're like, what are you talking about, conspiracy theorists? There's no New World Order. She kept saying the same thing, and then after the camera turned off, she said, I was trying to provoke you. So it's just all like a big game, keep the public in the dark, blah, blah, blah. But, I mean, we're not even trying to, like, be fancy-pants reporters. We just are trying to keep people in the light here. We're just trying to get people informed and free. There's the London Eye.
Yeah, we can see it there. If you're watching on prisonplanet.tv, infowars.com/B, as in Bilderberg, also infowars.com/show. Now, Alex, there's something I've been wanting to ask you since you got there. If I can ask you a quick question, what do the people think of your horrible British accent?
You bet. Did you randomly come by or did you hear we were out here? Oh, you're listening. You want to be on tape or not?
Nice to meet you.
You want to say something on camera or not?
No.
Well, God bless you, sir. It's great to run with so many listeners.
All the best.
God bless you, ma'am. God bless you. Wonderful to meet you. Man, we are just running into tons of people out here, Jakari and David. How exciting is it? They don't want us to know that humanity's awakening, do they?
No. And Alex, I asked you the question, what do the real British people think of your horrible British accent?
I think they like it. But one guy on the train said he was a listener, but then when I did the whole rim of the stool thing, he said, I think they ought to spend money to send you back. So
did you ask him what they thought about Pierce Morgan, your Pierce Morgan appearance?
I'm telling you, we're running into a ton of listeners out here, Jakari. This is crazy. It's like being in Fight Club or something, man. I was talking to the cops off record, and it was like Fight Club. I turned into the fat Tyler Durden. I'm sorry, what were you guys saying?
No, I was asking, did anybody have an opinion of your Pierce Morgan experience?
You've heard a ton of that. They said it was on every TV channel over here, yeah. Hey, buddy, what was your take of the Pierce Morgan thing? Did you hear about that?
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
What'd you think?
I thought he tore him apart. He deserved everything that he got, and I don't think he could have done better.
Did that come through, guys?
Yeah,
that's right. I don't know if you can hear. We're about to go out to break, So stay tuned, Infowars.com, Infowars.com/B as in Bilderberg, also PrisonPlanet.tv, and we'll be right back with more streaming from Alex Jones.
Hello, I'm Alex Jones. Myself, my family, the Infowars.com team want to relay to you and your families that we are intensifying our efforts against the globalist on every front. Infowars.com is leading the fight against the technocrats. But we can't do that without your help. By getting the films, bumper stickers, and t-shirts at Infowars.com, you will wake up people in your area and support our operation as we move to the next level. We need your help to spread the word like never before. They wish to hide themselves during this tectonic battle between the forces of freedom and darkness. You are the response to the globalist technocrats and their program of global eugenics dehumanization and ultimate extermination. The war is here. It's an info war. The spirit of 1776 versus the mindset of 1984.
We travel so much, and having a fake TV, well, it gives added peace of mind.
Burglars look for houses that appear to be easy targets, but fake TV can fool even professional burglars into thinking someone is home watching television.
As a recent widow living alone, it gives me great peace of mind to set my fake TV near a window and know that passing motorists and pedestrians will think someone is home watching TV when I'm actually away from home.
Fake TV easily plugs into any outlet, just like a light on a timer.
And they're so easy to use. You just plug them in and they're ready to go. Plus, they're so affordable that we have one upstairs and downstairs.
Fake TV is only $29.95 with free shipping. Order your fake TV by calling 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to faketv.com. That's 877-532-5388 or faketv.com. Fake TV, the burglar deterrent.
Hello, this is Ty Bollinger, author of the best-selling book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box. I want you to know some very important information. In 1985, President Ronald Reagan requested that Carnivora be sent directly to the White House at a time when only the president could obtain this world-class healer. Now, 27 years later, Carnivora capsules are used around the world to keep people healthy. Now you can protect yourself and your loved ones in this age of superbugs with 17 naturally occurring compounds that instinctively respond to abnormal cells only without harming a single normal cell. If you want to stay healthy, now's your chance to literally wake up your critical immune cells to attack harmful invaders that don't belong in your body. Call 1-866-VENUS-FLY or order from carnivora.com. That's carnivora.com. That's 1-866-836-8735, 1-866-VENUS-FLY, or visit carnivora.com. Protect your immune system. It's the only one you've got.
Folks, final segment of Overdrive here. We've got great listeners showing up quite a bit, like 10, 15 people now out here because we're broadcasting live from right by Big Bend, talking to a lot of great people out here. And England and the UK is really waking up to the New World Order as we cover Bilderberg 2013. Very, very exciting. And just a lot of listeners out here, a lot of people that are awake to what's going on, and people are really waking up to the shadow government. And the fact that there are just hundreds of articles, it was like 50 articles yesterday, 20 the day before, 15 the day before, exponential coverage, and the fact that the BBC has to come here and try to spin it, the London Telegraph has to spin it, the International Business Times, Financial Times, they're all covering it. It's very, very exciting. And now members of the British Parliament are criticizing Bilderberg in the midst of this big scandal dealing with lobbying, and that's something David Knight has been pointing out, is the big lobbying scandal. This is the ultimate lobbying scandal. And I keep repeating that because this information is key. So we'll continue to have live feeds tonight at Infowars.com/Bilderberg. People all over the world, just watch that space. They're all being archived there. also at Infowars.com and on the YouTube channels. We've got a bunch of videos we haven't even had time to upload yet from today and tomorrow. The big event kicks off with all the globalists arriving. We need activists all around that multi-thousand acre facility to catch all the limousines and people coming in. They've ordered the police to try to keep people away so they can't photograph the 20 to 50, it varies every year, globalists that arrive secretly who don't want to be photographed. So it's important that alternative, real grassroots media show up in mass to show what this would-be shadow government is up to. And I want to thank the listeners that have shown up, the media people to help us run camera here. Thank you very much. And just awesome to see all of you out here. It's crazy. About an hour and a half ago, I mentioned I was going to drive over here. And we've had a lot of people come by, and it's very, very exciting. How you doing, sir? And countless people honking when they drove by. And also out there, it just shows people are awake. And you're the future out there. You're the leaders. You're aware of what's going on. So start your own podcast. Start your own YouTube channel. Start speaking out in your community, your own newsletter, your own newspaper. We are the people. We're the resistance. We're the media. And we've now identified the shadow government. And we're going to force our elected governments who have been bought and paid for by these people to start responding to it. This is the beginning of the end of the globalist. Thank you so much for running camera for you. You're very, very sweet. You're awesome. Thank you. So that, without further ado, is the end of the main transmission. Jakari Jackson, David Knight, do you have any more points that you'd like to make?
Well, tomorrow is when things are really going to pick up, as you were saying, because that's when the conference actually starts. You've been doing preliminary work and talking about the background of what's being set up there, the fences, that sort of thing, the identity checks. But it's tomorrow that it's really going to get started. So we're going to see a lot more happening tomorrow.
Absolutely. And we're going to have more live feeds coming up tonight. And then before the show even starts, we're up like 6 hours ahead of you guys. So at 3 a.m. or so, live feeds start at Infowars.com/Bilderberg and follow us on Twitter at Real Alex Jones. But whatever you do, obviously most of you can't be here because they've destroyed the economy. We can barely afford to come here. So most of you can just simply spread the word on Twitter, Facebook, Infowars.com, YouTube, everywhere else. But look at just part of the crowd that has shown up by me just an hour and a half ago mentioning I was going to come here. And we've had people walking by waving that they're listeners. Truly, oh look, diplomatic immunity, royal vehicle driving by right there above the law. The globalists are no longer above the law. The UN and Monsanto are no longer above the law. We the people demand justice, and we're taking our planet back. So great job, guys, and good luck there on the nightly news. Tonight, the revolution against global tyranny will be televised. Gentlemen, so take us away. I'm signing off now with final images here on the Thames in the UK in jolly old England.
All right, that's Alex Jones on location out there at Bilderberg 2013. I'm Jakari Jackson along with David Knight. Check out the InfoWars Nightly News tonight, 7 p.m. Central. Also go to Infowars.com/B.
Visit GCNLive.com today.
Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new aqua.